10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You already know what time it is. ReviveIsAlive.com. Once again, ReviveIsAlive.com. Tune in. Revive is alive.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time.
About that time.
It's your girl POC. Hey! It's your girl POC.
Yep, you know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive. We are live right now at the 24th annual Lock Conference down here. Hey, beautiful, shut out. Yes, indeedy. But yes, we are live right now at the 24th annual Lock Conference down here in Philadelphia, man. South Philadelphia, be correct. We got your girl Z in the building.
What's up?
South
what's
Philadelphia
up?
Residents. You know what I'm saying?
What's up?
We live, Z. Yes, we can hear you, baby. What's
you
good?
You know, I'm holding it like I'm about to sing somewhere, but nonetheless.
Like what? And we got your boy, Stephon Lamar.
Take the stand.
How you feeling, Stephon? How you feeling?
I'm always simply swell, but I'm feeling especially swell today.
Especially swell.
Because you ate that good food.
You know what? I'm not swell because it was vegan, and vegan food don't have you all.
Yes.
Up.
Oh, my goodness, man. So let us tell you a little bit about, you know, our day that we started right now. So the day started around 9 o'clock, 9, 10 o'clock. We had to come through the setup. I mean, the setup was amazing. Just, you know, Stephon was everywhere. See, he left me during the setup. He met about 20 vendors. He came back with a moisturized beard. He came back with some shea butter on his wrist. I'm like, yo, you left me out here. Like, you over there getting moisturized on up. But, yeah, so.
I was working, baby.
Working for who? Okay.
Yes,
he was
indeed.
Being revived for revive.
Yes, he was. I'll give him that. I'll give you that, man. But yes, so it's when we got down here, it was just honestly so many different people. Everybody was saying good morning. Everybody
good.
Had
That's
a
dope.
Smile on their
right.
face. Because you think about it, Saturday, 9 o'clock, not too much sun out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You don't think you're going to get too many
little
smiles.
Little nippy outside. Yeah.
You're artisan every day, but yes, today yes. brighten everything up.
Yes, yes, man. So how was your experience, like, you know, just walking around, meeting the vendors, seeing who was actually out here today?
It was amazing. Like, it was just, like, another experience. This is my first time coming to the Lock Conference. My first time going around talking to different vendors, you know, and every person I met, you know, I can't wait to have all the people I met on the show and actually talk to them and get a bit more about, like, what they're about. Yeah, it was just amazing. That's just the best word, you know. I can go on and on. Like, you know, each person seems so, you know, and evident, you know, how solidified they were in their craft and their business and how much they loved it, you know. Each product that I saw or tried out, you know, the beer and everything, the beer.
I'm kind of jealous you got the product text already.
It felt so great. Everything was everything. Everything is everything.
Always, yes, indeed.
My expectations about what this was going to be.
And this is all of our first time, too.
Yeah, this is my first time, which is crazy if they have it here all the time. Because my brother, I live in South Philly. My brother went to this school. So I never even knew that they had things of this caliber in this school.
Yes, yes. And it's the 24th annual. 24th. I'm not sure if this is the, you know, the first time that they actually had it in this school.
Yeah.
But it has always been in Philadelphia. So I'm really excited.
Okay.
And like we were talking about earlier, you guys, the food here is amazing.
That's what I experienced.
I had my first ever vegan crab cake. I've never had a vegan crab cake before until today. And it was honestly, truly amazing. It was something that I will vouch for because when it comes to this vegan thing, I kind of get a little confused because I'm not a vegan. I'm a pescatarian. I still do eat seafood.
Right.
So when it comes to this vegan thing, I kind of get a little confused because it's like, how do you have vegan chicken? How can you have vegan cutlets?
So they use different seasonings. So that's the reason. So I was vegan for a while, and I stopped just like because what you said, because a lot of it was seitan and like different herbs and stuff like that to make it taste like it. But that's a lot of bread. That's it's a lot of breading. So I'm gonna just put it like that. So when I was doing all of that, I was noticing that everything on my plate was a starch.
Okay.
So unless it's like a raw diet, because I want to be vegan as well. I would probably go like Dr. Sabi or raw.
Okay. I really want to move. I got his book in my house.
I love
too.
Him. Mm-hmm. And I've done it for a while where I didn't eat anything, and I was telling you how healthy I felt, and even went to the doctors and they confirmed how healthy I was. But it's expensive.
Very, very.
And then you need the herbs. You know, not the herbs. You need the vitamins. To
and
counteract
you
what you
and
don't
you
have.
You need the money too.
Listen.
No, I was just going to say that like a lot of people say that it's expensive, but honestly, two things. It doesn't have to be so expensive starting off. That's
I'm perfect. Greedy.
I feel like once you
I
really
disagree.
Get into it, then it gets expensive because you want to spend this and that and everything.
Well, I like Z, she just added extra cranberries.
That's
extra
what I'm saying. I love vegetables, so I want all of them.
Right. And it's like the best investment to make. Like, you know,
it is.
Like, to invest in your body. And
it
your
is.
Wellness.
I was when I was doing the 9-to-5 thing before I pursued my dream, it was easier.
Right.
But now that I'm pursuing this, it's like okay. So I kind of went back to the fish thing and went over to instead of the vegan because I wasn't able to buy all the stuff. Plus, I was making like walnut meat, so you would need sun dried tomato, amino acids. Like I was in that thing,
right.
So I was making everything from scratch.
Okay,
and I'm like, Lord. Okay, yeah, I did. You know, I started following people. Like, it's a lady on Instagram, not to plug her. I don't personally know her, but she does cooking with plants.
Yeah.
And she's, like, over in the U.K. So she told me how to make, like, dips from sunflower seeds. Sunflower seeds is $2 a pack.
I love sunflower seeds.
So
I
what you do is, you do, and it's delicious. So you
I
do miso, sunflower seeds. It's, like, onion powder, scallions.
I love onion powder.
Scallions and something else, and you make it, and it's a dip, and you dip it, and I would put it in salads, and it would taste like Caesar dressing. So I was in that thing. No, ask me where I'm at today.
I was in that thing.
But I would. It's called Cooking with Plants. She makes her own nut cheeses. It's a place downtown where they make nut cheeses, and it's really delicious. So, but it's easier to make it from scratch because you know what's going into your food.
Right.
So she would literally have all the little different things, and again, it's called Cooking with Plants. And I would do it, and it was like seven or eight ingredients.
Front?
No, it's
okay.
On YouTube.
Okay,
it's called Cooking with Plants. She's a vegan now. She lost weight.
Oh, right.
She's in the UK, white lady, but she's in the UK. But she really would break it down, and I appreciated it. But she would teach it with the cheap stuff, like scallions are cheap. Sunflower seeds are cheap, and they're healthy.
I love
onion powder. You can get some lemon juice. You can squeeze that by hand. So it's ways, like you said, to do it. But I think I kind of got busy and lazy. But I was, like, staying within that realm where I would eat, like, kale, buy a big bag of kale, and put that in there with some avocado, and then put more sunflower seeds. And mushrooms.
Yo,
so
have you guys
good.
Ever had a grilled avocado?
No.
Changes your whole life.
I never
grilled
it.
You know what? Everybody's putting their beef franks on the grill, and they're putting their burgers on the grill. And you say, you know what?
What?
I don't eat meat anymore. And they say, well, all we have is avocado. And you say, throw that thing on a grill?
That's probably delicious. It
changes your life.
Because it's like a grilled fruit.
You see what I'm saying?
Like it would melt or something, but it
no,
would,
not at
it might caramelize
right.
That thing.
You just got to keep flipping it. Just
it makes it caramelize?
It just a little bit.
That's
little
a good
bit.
Eat.
So to what
that's
you
a good eat.
That's actually called a thing. Like when food is made to look like something else, it's androgynous.
Yeah.
And actually, I was thinking about the word when she said it because... When this woman that walked past said you were Grace Jones and she was Nefertiti.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Grace Jones was into androgyny. Dressing like something. Androgyny is when something turns itself or the person turns himself or herself into something else that she or it is not. So the food turning into a crab cake when it's really vegetable, that's called androgyny.
Awesome. Yeah, you know, that's like jackfruit. I was about to say, you know, you can do jackfruit.
Jackfruit
is like pulled, like that's, it makes it look like pulled chicken or pork, but it's the fruit and you shred it. So, I mean, and that's the problem because I know the stuff, y'all, but I just kind of fell off in, like, the last year. Like, last year, I wouldn't pick up anything processed. I wouldn't pick up no chips. I was eating, well, not like, the beginning last year. It was, like, nuts instead. And then I was like, give me the chips, cake, pies. And now we got to this one.
The pies. But the chips, cake, pies.
I eat it all. I put it all together.
The chip cake pies. She wants all of it. Yo, but the best part about it, she still does eat healthy. You know what I'm saying? Because there would be things she would simply say. Because one, when we were at the Women of Media Conference, we were literally on our feet all day from like 7 to 7, and she's the only one that didn't eat. We were over there sneaking in. We were getting it in, and Z was like, nope, I'm good. I'm good.
What, like all water fast?
No, when I fast, I do absolute fast because I don't eat a lot of things. So because I don't eat a lot of things, like just doing like water and like fruits and stuff like that is not a fast for me. So I went to absolute fast.
Right, so that's so all water.
No, nothing.
No water.
Hello, hello. How are you? How are you? How are you?
The longest I've done it is 3 days. That's when I told you I was looking. It was like, Lord, is that, you know, you looking ahead, Lord.
Is that fine? You did yours
you
on four, right?
The sky.
Yeah, I did mine for 4 years.
4 days, yep.
No. Nothing.
How do you do that? No water?
Nothing.
You're not supposed to do that to yourself.
No, absolute fast. People do absolute fast.
For real?
Spiritually, you are on a high. Spiritually, you really are. Like, when I tell you I be sitting in and you be in. So, normally on the third day, I normally make sure I'm home. Because that your body is just, like, mush. Mm-hmm. But especially when you, like, on the go and it's used to you drinking or having something. But normally, I do absolute fast. So I normally, like, the first day into the second day, I'm good to go out. But that third day, I don't play that. I'm home.
And the crazy part is I try. I literally got to, like, and I suck because I say this all the time. I got to probably, like, the 21st, the 22nd hour, and I tapped all the way out.
That's the first day.
I just could not get past that first. It's, like, the 21st, 22nd midday.
Yeah.
And I was only supposed to be doing it for 24 hours. When I left Nigeria, I promised one of the Muslim men there that the first day of Ramadan, which was June 15th this year, that I would, not June 15th, May 15th, that I would make sure, the first day of Ramadan, that I would promise him that I wouldn't, and I broke my promise.
Do you normally do those type of fasts all the time, or that was your first time?
This was my first time.
So you did well, because I think that's the thing about it, is to expect somebody to be, and like, I didn't start off doing absolute fast. Mm-hmm. I started off fasting for a couple of hours, then it moved to 8 hours, then it moved to all day, and then it moved to 2 days, and then the first time I did that, I was doing water. Yeah, so I would do rounds of fasting, because that's hard. Mm-hmm. That's cold turkey. So I think you did really well that you got 21
thank you.
Hours.
Thank
in
you.
Because
I got 21.
I didn't do that like
definitely.
From the word. That's a lot.
But you know,
21.2.
You see what I'm saying? Thank you, Stefan. Thank you, man. But I want to get back a little bit into this law conference. Once again, you guys, if you're tuning in right now, we are live on reviveisalive.com. Make sure you guys follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at @revive_POC. We're trying to get this live visual popping for you guys so you can see the views and everything that's going on down here at this conference. Make sure you guys stay locked to the timeline. I want to say shout out to the security. You know what I'm saying? They was making sure nobody I got through them double doors.
I did. What they both said.
About,
they didn't check my bag.
Yeah, I want to smash a shout out, but
I told.
They ain't do their job.
Well, earlier when it was coming down to the time to not let nobody in, they locked them doors.
They did. See, that's what's wrong, because it's all men. They should have had one female, because she would have been like, check her too. Don't assume, brother. What if I was the way in?
What if I was the tall one with the purple hair?
Bags too. It could be something in that thing.
You're right. It is something in the bag. Don't be out here snitching.
Just the Lord and a couple of
just the Lord.
Got the Lord in my bag. I got my neck.
I felt like security
on my neck.
You better prophesy.
But no, for real, what, in my opinion, security was doing their job. This morning, you should have seen them.
They shut the doors.
They locked the doors. I felt like we was in, what's the high school when the principal put the chains on the door and they couldn't get out?
Oh, Free Mr. Clark.
Mr. Clark.
Joe Clark. Fairy side.
That's exactly what I felt
lean
like.
On me.
You couldn't get out or in this mug. Like, I was like, No,
that's one of my favorite movies.
Shout out to Mr. Clark. You know,
yo, he ain't play. You can call me Crazy Joe. You can call me Batman.
Wasn't that in Philly too? Am I tripping?
No, was it?
Was
no,
it?
I don't think they
East
did that.
High,
in,
it,
in no,
Philly?
You never saw Lean on Me?
Oh yeah, with Samuel.
Well,
yeah, but it wasn't. It wasn't here.
Lean
she was
on
saying
Shaggy
where did
Will
they record it? No,
Lean
I didn't
me.
Do that here. I don't think so. But it was definitely in some type of urban neighborhood.
I got to Google it.
She about to find where it was.
Lean on Me?
That was Morgan Freeman.
He going to say Samuel L. Jackson, though.
Which one was that? He was in Not Lean on Me. Coach
Carter. Okay, you're right. Don't compare the two, though. But he did lock him out, so you're right. I can see.
So where did they record it?
New Jersey. It was in New Jersey.
Okay, then that's why you do it, because it's really
it was close. So
close to First
to
of all, that made $31 million in 1989.
Yes, it was
that
a black
was ridiculous.
Movie. Let's talk about
no,
it.
No, but that's ridiculous.
how is that ridiculous?
That's good, I mean. Like,
I'm about to say, that ain't even on Moneyworld right now.
But no, in 1989 it was.
And it came out
on March. It was a black movie in 1989. All black heads, mostly.
Shout out. And it came out on March 3rd. Shout out to Harmony, the goddess. Yeah. That's actually her Earth Day birthday, which is March 3rd.
Well, he been that age since Lean on Me. He still look exactly the same. Morgan Freeman looked like 1989.
Stop playing with him like that.
I'm telling you, Morgan Freeman has been old since I was born, and he's still old to that. I don't understand what it
That's
is.
That's a good thing. He aging like Cicely Tyson.
He ain't aged at all. He's not real.
Just like Cicely Tyson. I don't
think Cicely Tyson is real. She's aged. He's not aged at all. He's not real. I don't know who Morgan Freeman. I don't think he's from here.
that just mean black don't crack, and as we look around, we can tell. You know what I'm saying? Black is not cracking.
He ain't. I don't know what kind of black that
is. It's so much black in this building than what we in right now.
Yeah,
it's a lot going on.
And they look good too.
If a white person come up here, they're gonna be black.
If a white they gonna turn around if they come in here, because they gonna be nervous.
And I want to go to a quick break. Right after this quick break, I want to get into some of these garbs that we've seen, some of the clothes that we've seen, the jewelry that we've seen. I also want to talk to some of these vendors, as well as get into some of these locks. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of locks in the building today.
Check the food vendors. Yes.
Yo, Z, we got to get Stephon to take his head off so we can see his locks at the lock conference. He's gonna take his head off at the conference. I'm just playing with you, baby. I'm just playing.
He was in that thing yesterday. Yes, he was twisting him yesterday.
Manifesting, baby. You're manifesting.
I'm
what
surprised
you
ain't get that done, too.
What?
Get your hair done. They ain't got no people doing hair back there.
Oh, they do got some hair back there. They got some lock technicians.
You should get his. This is the perfect place to find the right person.
A lock technician.
Because you,
right?
their locks look good.
A lot of them.
I ain't seen no bad locks.
One of the daughters this morning. What was her name?
Sakina.
Her hair, and she has that lock jewelry, man. Definitely.
I have not seen anybody so thus far that have had bad locks since I've been in here. And I don't have locks, but I enjoy seeing when people take care of their locks.
Yes.
It looks really good when they do so.
And the crazy part is I do not take care of my locks.
You don't? They look good.
Thank you.
Well, what you do to them?
I just did little front, but back, you, side to side to it. But
well, you do more than some people do. They don't even wash them, and you can tell.
Because
they look like when they started them, but they just stayed in their position.
Yes. We about to go to a quick commercial break, man. Right after this quick commercial break, we'll be back with more information going on here at the 24th Annual Lock Conference. You will also be hearing from some of the vendors. We're also going to get into some of these clothes that they got going on. We're going to get this live popping so you can see some of the visuals as well that's going on down here right now. Yo, okay. Stephon, tell them where we at. Tell them the address. Read them right off the front of the card.
It's not over until 9 o'clock tonight.
9 p.m. Oh, wow. It's a 2-day conference, man.
Yeah, right. So it's going to be tomorrow as well.
That's dope.
The address is 3301 Tasker Street in South Philadelphia.
Pull up, Philly. Pull up. And Z, you know the name of the school.
Auden Reed High School.
Make sure you guys pull up.
Auden Reed High School. They do great things in here, even though y'all don't always hear it. Look at this great thing. Guys, you know, it's a lot of things that happen around here with the kids. And so, you know, the schools get a bad rep. But they do a lot of stuff for the community, though.
South Philly is super gentrified, but we're going to talk about this
on the other side of this break, man.
Make sure you guys stay locked. Turn your radios up. It's me, your girl, POC. I got your girl, Z, and your boy, Stephon Lamar, with me, man. We rocking out all day until about 4 o'clock today. Make sure you guys spread the word. Spread the message. RevivalsAlive.com is the place where you can find us. Let's go.
Man, I'm done with social media. All the injustice and brutality going around, and it's like they're trying to suppress our voice. We're trying to get the message out there, and you can't even share empowerment and what's going on around the country either.
Nah, don't be dumb with social media, though. It's a tool, and there is a place where we have a voice. It's a Let's Buy Black 365 social network. You do anything you would on any other social network. Post pictures, videos, status updates, share resources and community news. But on Let's Buy Black 365, it's a platform for us and by us to tell our messages.
Whoa, that's like a digital underground railroad.
What's the name of that site again?
It's letsbuyblack365.com.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's all about networking, and you get points, right?
Yeah, the more you network, post, and share, the more points you get. Plus, you get points for posting pictures, sharing information, attending community events, and inviting others to network with you on the app.
Wow, that's all I need to know. I'm gonna go download that app right now.
Now, better yet, let me invite you so I can get some points. It's all about empowerment and solutions, y'all.
Yeah, that's what's up. I'm all in.
Let's do it. Let's share our stories.
Let's buy Black365.com.
You are listening to Time for an Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
Are you a startup business? Are you a local business? Are you an artist? Are you looking for someone to distribute your content? Revive Radio is the place to be. Come advertise with us at Revive Radio right now. You can find that advertising page at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Advertise with Revive. We are reaching thousands of millennials all across the world. And once again, reviveisalive.com is where you can find that information. Know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl POC, host of Revive. We are live right now once again at the 24th annual Philadelphia Lock Conference, man. I'm really excited. Make sure you guys get down here, man. It's $10 each day. We're going live each and every day, Saturday and Sunday, so make sure you guys get here. It starts at 12 noon each day of the conference, man. We got a special guest sitting next to us. I stopped this young lady just literally off the mat, the strip of her hair. I wanted to get a bun like her one day, so I had to let her know. You know what I mean? She 8 years in the game when it's come to this lock journey. So I wanted to ask you a little bit about your locks, especially because you're so young. And I know, like, a lot of people don't like locks because you can't take it out. You can't do it over. You can't get, you know, the long hair. But you actually have really long hair. Yeah. Definitely. So I wanted to ask you, first and foremost, is this your first time at the Lock Conference?
I've been a part of the... This is my second time, actually. Awesome. I came when I was younger because my uncles were modeling in a... one of the shows.
Awesome. Okay. So you're here this time because you're modeling in one of the shows? You got the hair for it. You got the hair for it. So you're here to just, you know, be a part of the conference. I see you here with your mom. Shout out to your number one fan. She right here. You know what I'm saying? So you're here to just experience the conference. What are you actually looking forward for today?
Well, I wanted to get different stuff for my hair, like the hair jewels.
Yes,
and stuff,
me too,
like,
girl.
Accessorize my hair more. But, yeah.
So you're here to dress your hair up a little bit. Yo, Z, I'm trying to get like her. She's trying to dress her hair.
Listen,
I think it takes, like you said, it takes confidence, because in a day where it's bundles popping, for you to be natural and, mm-hmm. and comfortable with who she is dope.
Definitely. Yeah. And what made you actually want to start your lock journey, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, when I was younger, my mom used to do my hair, and it hurt a lot.
Me too. I'm very tender-headed. And they try to pull it too tight for no reason. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Come on, Ma. We ain't need it like that tight. Now we don't got no edges. You know what I'm saying? And then they put the grease on the forehead for no reason. But what you were saying, what made you want to start your journey?
So my biological dad and my sister's dad had locks, and I wanted to try it out.
Awesome.
And I saw a lot of people walking down the street with them, and so I was like, I found them interesting, so I wanted to try it myself.
Awesome. And when it comes to your locks, you know what I mean, do you wash them, like, you know, every 3 months? Like, how do you treat your locks? Because one thing that Z says, a lot of people don't treat the locks, and you can tell when they don't treat their locks. So how do you keep up with your locks to keep them? Because your hair is really, really beautiful.
I oil my hair once every two weeks.
Okay.
And then I would get my hair done like every month to keep it conditioned.
Okay. Awesome. And my last question to you is, so when it comes to the heaviness, you know, putting it in the bun, because you have a beautiful bun right now, does that ever become a problem for you? Because a lot of people complain about it becomes too heavy, that's why they cut them. And you've been in the game for about 8 years now.
Well, my hair, it is heavy, but I guess I got used to it.
Okay.
And, like, the longer my hair gets, the more difficult it takes to put in styles.
Okay, I'm with you. I love her bun. And are you in high school?
Yeah.
Awesome. What grade are you in?
11.
What's up with the high school year? You know what I'm saying? Like, how was it in high school? Tell us a little bit about high school. We've been out of high school for a very long time.
It's difficult. I don't like 11th grade.
You're going to want to go back when you might be. You're going to be like, can I do a redo?
Why you say it's difficult?
Well, me, I go to a boarding school.
Okay.
I go to
shout out to her mom, her number one fan.
Yeah, I mean, I go to Girard College. And
awesome.
Like,
you make it. I mean, that's a boarding school, but that's a really good school, though.
Yeah, Girard College, I mean, sometimes.
But Girard College is a really good school, though.
I mean, and it's not like I got anybody else there to talk to about my hair, because I'm okay. The only one with locks.
That makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. You got your brother, though. He got locks?
Yeah.
And you look like a dancer. Are you a dancer? You look like you just... I don't know. You're giving me like an artist kind of a vibe. Like you do something, yes. But so when it comes to keeping your hair up while you're in school, how does that work? You know what I mean? Because you're not home. You just know how to take care of it.
Yeah, I just oil it and wrap it up before I go to sleep.
I know I said this is my last question. This is really my last question. Do you let people touch your hair? That's the one thing that bothers my soul, is when people want to come and touch my hair.
I don't like people touching
not
hair.
Not at all. It's a thing, but just with dreadlocks, like when people just think they can touch it because you have dreadlocks or you have locks, huh?
People do that with my skin.
I don't like it.
They'll ask me if I have on makeup, and like, really?
Yeah. I mean, one time I was in the lunch line and I just felt something touching my hair. I got uncomfortable. I was like, okay. I turned around and somebody was touching my hair.
I'm with you, man. And I appreciate you for coming through. Do you have like a social media outlet you want anybody to follow you on? You know, you got people listening to you right now. You want to get your followers up? It's up to you.
Sure. My Instagram name long, though.
All right, do your thing. Spell it out. You got to probably spell it out for them, because, you know, you got people out there who can't spell. I ain't making fun of nobody who listening, but I'm just saying.
All right, got it. _ONLY.X.ME_.
And what does that spell?
That's only me.
Oh, _ONLY_ME. I love it, man. Shout out to _ONLY_ME. I'm actually going to make sure I follow you too as well. She's trying to throw it up for the live. Yes, indeed, man. We appreciate you coming through. Thank you for stopping by. Thank you, Mom, for allowing her to sit down and talk with us today, man. Yo, Z, we about to go back to a quick break until the next guest pop up, and then we'll be back live, man. You already know what time it is. It's Meet Your Girl, PLC. We'll be back. Revivalsalive.com. Spread the word. Spread the message. We are now live. Let's go.
You are listening to Time for an Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
going to distribute your content, Revive Radio is the place to be. Come advertise with us at Revive Radio right now. You can find that advertising page at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Advertise with Revive. We are reaching thousands of millennials all across the world. And once again, reviveisalive.com is where you can find that information. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. All I need is one mic. You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time. It's your girl POC. Yep. You know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive. We are back live right now on reviveisalive.com. Once again, that is reviveisalive.com. Make sure you guys follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at revive_POC. Also, we are live right now on our Instagram line, so make sure you guys check that out at revive_POC as well. Hello. I love your hair, by the way. Definitely, man. Definitely. Yeah, we are really live right now. But yes, I love your hair and I love your bush too. It's so many different amazing hairstyles in this building right now, man. Shout out to all the beautiful queens rocking their crowns right now, man, proudly. You know what I'm saying? Crowns are rocking right now. What you about to say, Z?
Oh, I like her shoes.
I can't even see the shoes. The table hot in the shoes,
like,
man.
It's like a funny print.
I'm with it. Oh, okay, I see it now. People out here getting fly. They threw that thing on today. They threw that thing on today. They, you know what time it is. Each and every time, man. Definitely. Yo, Alicia, what's good? How you feeling?
What's going on,
y'all? Live on Revive for the first time. Shout out to Alicia, man. I want her to introduce herself. She is definitely a part of Revive. Yeah, she's a part of the Revive team. She does a lot of our graphics, also the photography for Revive. But she's never been on the airways. So go ahead and introduce yourself to the people who are
going
to hear you, who's listening.
What's going on? My name is Alicia. I go by Exhibit A Art Design. You can follow me at Exhibit A Art Design on Instagram. That is the only platform that I'm on right now, so just follow me on there. I do custom art pieces. I like to do black artwork. I have some of my artwork
black
out here.
Black and proud.
Yes, black and I'm proud, yes. I bring all types of visions to life. So if it's photography, if it's artwork, graphic design I'm getting into now. It's
okay.
I'm excited for it.
I'm with you. And I appreciate you. If I have never said it before, I'm going to say it live on air so everyone can hear me. I appreciate all that you do, you know, for Revive Radio. Thank you with the graphics and definitely with the visuals. You know, I'm always pushing views versus vision. And speaking of views versus vision, because you have been walking around all day with the, you know what I'm saying, with the trigger. You got the, you know, you got the bullets, you know.
I'm not
you got
a hitter,
it loaded, you know.
But I'll shoot you.
Out here shooting right now. How is it? What do you see? Like, how has it been for you, you know, being behind
people?
The scenes?
Are absolutely beautiful. Everybody is absolutely
all
beautiful.
All different shades and sizes.
I love it. All different shapes and sizes. Yes.
The little boy, the little girl, the twins made my heart melt. You missed them. It, D. Earlier this morning, they was out here like a bundle of joy, just running around. I'm like, are they twins? And he like, yes. And what was
they
it? Hakima?
It was like Makim. It was like
Akeem. It was two Akeem.
And Makeem.
Yeah, it was like, they was, yeah.
It was a boy and a girl, though.
It was
so cute.
It was a boy and a girl.
The Keem.
Why are you always playing? But yes, what have you seen behind that camera of yours, though, Alicia? What have you seen out here at the conference so far?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm getting lost in this. How are you? All right, so there is jewelry, there's natural soap, there are bath bombs.
I'm trying to get me some yarn and ASAP.
Yes, natural butter. We have butters over here in all types of flavors. We have live art. Shout out to Keisha and Creative Studios doing her live art. Michelle Obama.
She is really doing a live painting over there. Peep that.
We're
peep
to get
that.
Her on here.
You knew her. Remember, you walked up to her. She was like, I know this one. I know this woman.
Oh, Kim. I think her name is
Keisha.
Keisha.
Lord Jesus.
She over here talking about Keisha, and then you talking about Kim.
Kim.
We don't know
Kim, Nisha, Lil Rhonda, and her friend. I love. What was the name of that song? Kim, Keisha, Lil Rhonda, and her friend. Yeah, I. All right, whatever. Hello, King. How are you doing today? How are you? We are live broadcasting right now from Revive Radio right now. You look like you wanted to know what was going on, so I was trying to tell you what was going on. I love your outfit, mind you, by the way. Is that something that you made yourself? Okay. Ghana, awesome. I love it. I got mine from Nigeria. I was trying, you know what I'm saying, blend for the culture this morning. I was like, yo, I got to put something on for the culture. Got to do it for the culture this morning.
ASOS and stuff. They ain't got nothing to do with it. But I put it on my blank.
But they got a lot. They definitely got a lot of clothes out there, too. Like, they got, have you been in the gym yet? I don't think you've been in the gym yet, Z. Have you been in the gym yet, Alicia?
No, the auditorium is all I went to.
Oh my! It's every hallway in this school it's like over 500 vendors. If you can see on the pamphlet, the brochure, it's an entire map of how you get around this place. It's about 500 vendors up in here, and they're all. You want to hear something, Z? They're all black owned.
I love this.
They're all black owned.
They have dance classes, y'all.
They got workshops going on. Workshops,
chess.
For the kids, everything.
I know how to play spades. The hood checker.
I'll walk away from that one.
That's the black people.
Why you play? You definitely got to learn how to play spades. I would do agree with you on that one. You can't be black if you don't know how to play spades. I do agree with you on that one.
It's my hook card.
No, give it back.
I'm sorry. I cannot play spades. I love grits. All right. So, see, thank you. I can have my card back. Thank you.
Y'all, they over here exchanging black cards. Mind you, they both eating like vegan food. Talking about black people don't eat vegan food. You want to talk about it?
They're all vegan vendors.
Yeah, that is crazy. We are changing our little diets out here, man. We are definitely changing our diet because we tired of passing down them diseases. We tired of passing down diseases, so we changing our diets.
Yeah,
because we all of us
and the sugar. Like when I noticed when I cut out like chicken and stuff, your body craves sugar because it's the lack of protein.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And so that's why I said cookies, cakes, and pies. You don't hear me saying chicken, but you know none of that. I'm over it. But you put a cookie.
Yo Z, ever since you said something about him not checking bags, he been checking bags.
He checking that bag that I told. And it's recorded. He didn't check the pregnant lady.
Checked the pregnant lady.
He didn't check me, and I.
Yo, every time you come through, I laugh more than I talk, bruh. Leave me alone, bruh.
He done
checked the pregnant lady. Because you're live, baby, so I can hear you, you know what I'm saying, on the speaker.
And then
so daddy over here checking the pregnant lady. No, man. Don't be doing that to her.
I feel like security guard
is listening to you. She was a beautiful pregnant lady, too, by the way. She had some nice natural hair. Her bush was popping, man. But we never even got... Oh, yeah. Them branches nuts are cute.
There's two of them.
I like that.
Yes.
When I first started my locks, I would not wear my locks down. No, not URD. I was part of URD. Shout out to URD. No, we're not URD. We're Revive Radio. Yes. Revive Radio. That's what it is. It's the station. No, it's not a number. Just Revive Radio. No numbers. What's your name? Let's talk to you. What's your name?
I've seen him before.
Huh? Brother Timothy. Come talk to us, Brother Timothy. How you feeling today, Brother Timothy?
Well, I feel good because I'm talking to you three ladies in an Afrocentric place.
Yes.
An Afrocentric time.
Yes.
I like around black people in this racist time period.
Time that we are in.
Guess
you're
what?
Right.
All that we will overcome,
because
the future is always better than the past. But we got to learn from the past in order to take it to the future.
I'm with that, brother. So what can you teach us right now in the present that we can take to our future?
To learn to adjust.
Learn to adjust. I love
that's
that.
Right. Stay focused on your goals, and never feel defeated.
Never feel defeated.
Because we have overcome every obstacle as black people.
That's a fact.
And guess what?
What?
Love y'all for being here.
But no, I got one more question for you. Okay. So we're live right now at the 24th annual LOC conference, right? And this is my first time here. You know what I mean? This is all of our first time here, actually. Yes. How many times have you been here, or is this your first time?
No, this is about my fourth time. Let me tell you
time,
something.
Okay.
When people told me about the LOC conference, I said, well, I don't wear locks. So, and a friend of mine said, just come anyway. because all our friends are there. Mm-hmm. Because I'm pro-black, so I know I'm going to be, what they're inviting me to, it's going to be black. And I said, this is more than just locks. This is everything here. Uh-huh. It's everything that we do, see, and hear that's positive.
Exactly.
And I come try to make this an Adun Day. This is my fall Adun Day, yes. And my summer Adun Day is it's all South Street. Day.
Exactly.
So, you know, 360 degrees of knowledge, black people, understanding and wisdom of the God and first and being in the universe.
Are you from Philly?
Yes, I am. South and West Philadelphia.
Okay, so that's why you...
What about yourself?
Oh, no, I'm from Washington, D.C. I'm not from the area.
Let me tell you something. I'm a Kappa from Lincoln University.
F-5 Cheney Star University. East. Let's talk about it. The first and HBCU. You want to talk about it? We
well,
can talk
we
about it.
Well, we both are first because you're the first to provide a certificate. We're the first to give a four-year
degree.
Undergrad.
Okay. Guess you want to get into his argument?
We can't get away from Wilberforce because they were the first one to own their university.
Oh, you're right.
So you got three firsts.
You know your facts, okay?
Right.
You know your facts.
The thing is that they used to come on Cheney's campus, mm-hmm. and they used to come on ours. Nothing like that triangle, Howard, Lincoln, Cheney, and Morgan. Mm-hmm. And guess what? I love D.C. But you're going to be here from D.C. to Philadelphia because the Kappa Conclave is in 19. So everybody around the world is going to come to Philadelphia because our conclave
when
is here.
When is it?
It's the last week of July, first week of August.
Oh, in 2019.
That's right.
Okay, so there's going to be some fine brothers out here shimmying
and
up and down
you,
these streets in the city
right.
of Philadelphia.
You
so you try
and
get me ready. That's what you just said.
That's right. Love you. Did you pledge anything, Cheney?
No, I wish, though.
That's okay. Listen, I wish. In fact, you black, you already are both accepted in the nation.
Both of my sisters are AKAs, though.
Oh, that's good.
Both
you
of my sisters.
You can be that or anything you want.
Yeah.
Stay strong, beautiful.
Thank you. I appreciate you, Brother Timothy.
Peace, love, and soul.
No doubt, no doubt. We got Stephon back in the building. I'm sure he got some good news for us. We about to go to a quick commercial break. Then right after this quick commercial break, we're going to be up next with some of our guests who are here live at the 24th Annual Lock Conference. They got the dashikis in the building. Check out the dashiki that just came through. She got like a split going down the front of hers. I never seen that before. But we about to go to a quick commercial break. You already know what time it is. It's Meet Your Girl POC. We'll be back live. Make sure you guys spread the word, spread the message. Time for an awakening. Thank you guys for allowing us to come through.
Yes, my raps are filled with rage.
One of these days, we gotta bust back for the homies.
You have to be logical. You know, if I know that in this hotel room, they have food every day, and I'm knocking on the door every day to eat, and they open the door, let me see the party, let me see like them throwing salami all over the, I mean, just like throwing food around, where they're telling me there's no food in here. You know what I'm saying? Every day. I'm standing outside trying to sing my way in. You know what I'm saying? We are hungry, please let us in. We are hungry, please let us in. After about a week, that song is going to change to we hungry, we need some food. After 2-3 weeks, it's like, you know, give me all the food, ragging out the door. And after a year, you just like, you know what I'm saying? I'm picking the lock, coming through the door, blasting. You know what I'm saying? It's like you hungry. You reached your level. You don't want any more. We asked 10 years ago. We was asking with the Panthers. We was asking with them, you know, with civil rights movement. We was asking, you know. Now those people that were asking, they're all dead and in jail. So now what do you think we're going to do? Ask?
I put my gun away and grab my AK. It's getting hectic. I can't call it. House full of alcoholics. Now a nigga's under pressure.
It's true. James Baldwin said, I am not who you say I am. Mm-hmm. And he talked about his father who believed the lie that white America had told him, the stereotypical representation of his blackness, not the brilliant, beautiful black man that he was, not the independent author of his own existence. He was dependent upon a culture that would demonize him and give him a sense of himself that was limited and circumscribed. So James Baldwin wanted to break out of that box, right. And he wanted black America to break out of that box. And as the first day of Black History Month, this celebrates the fact that black history is not just for black people, it's for everybody. Toni Morrison is great for all people. John Coltrane is great for all people. Whoopi Goldberg is great for all of America.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? It's the truth series.
I agree about the unity part, about Trump's need to bring everyone together, but I disagree about the white lash. And the reason is that President Obama got elected. He got elected in 2008 and he got reelected. And a lot of white people came out and voted for him. He got a lot of those voters. The country united in 2008. I don't care if you were Hispanic or African-American or Caucasian. I don't care what you were. You united under his message of hope and change. And then you reelected him. So I don't think people were rejecting President Obama. This had nothing to do with race for me. This had to do with two flawed candidates and people wanting change, just the way they did want in 2008. They wanted change. And this time they wanted an outsider. And they looked at Hillary Clinton and they said, I don't think she's going to bring change. I think she's part of the establishment. The system is broken. She's part of a broken system. Let's go with someone else.
President Obama did not pour gasoline on racism and say, go light a match. He did not do that. This guy did that. That's the difference between Obama and Trump.
But they weren't voting against President Obama. They're voting against Hillary Clinton.
This guy exacerbated and pulled out of the woodwork all the racism that was underlying there.
One thing that happened, though, I was actually talking with Matthew Dowd behind the scenes, and he was saying that some of the people that didn't actually show up were Democrats. And one of the things that could be identified as a problem is, right away from the beginning, everyone put their weight behind, well, Hillary will be the candidate. It was almost like, I'm not saying any systems were rigged. I'm just saying the DNC in their own mind and everyone in the public had decided Hillary's going to be our representative. But they maybe didn't listen to what other people in the party may have wanted, because that was the number that didn't reflect what everyone else was saying.
Yeah, that's probably true. That they didn't have enough of a primary fight.
Really go back and forth. And Donald Trump actually had a higher turnout in Latino and black voters than Mitt Romney did.
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
And he said the system was rigged.
Yeah, right.
Pick up. Let's say they listen to the cops and get in the car. Look what happened to Freddie Gray.
Yeah, and what if they make it all the way to the station?
Mm-hmm.
You remember Sandra Bland?
And let's say they do make it to trial.
Mm-hmm.
You see where that gets us? Don't you get it, Bo? The system is rigged against us.
Maybe it is, Dre. But I don't want to feel like my kids are living in a world that is so flawed that they can't have any hope.
Oh, so you want to talk about hope, Bo? Obama ran on hope. Remember when he got elected? And we felt like maybe, just maybe, we got out of that bad place and made it to a good place. That the whole country was really ready to turn the corner. You remember that amazing feeling we had during the inauguration? I was sitting right next to you. And we were so proud. And we saw him get out of that limo and walk alongside of it and wave to that crowd. Tell me you weren't terrified when you saw that. Tell me you weren't worried that someone was going to snatch that hope away from us like they always do. That is the real world, Bo. And our children need to know that that's the world that they live in.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me. Ooh, 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 ooh. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. Some new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me. Stars, when you shine, you know how I feel. Scent of the pine, you know how I feel.
Time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, PLC host Revive. Today is Winning Wednesday, so you already know each and every Winning Wednesday, we have a jam-packed show for you guys here on Time for the Awakening. I need you guys to give us a call right now, 215-490-9832. Once again, that number is 215-490-9832. And you already know reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com is the place for you to be. Click that link in my bio, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_PLC.
Hey, did y'all see the stuff I posted on my wall?
No, it didn't even show up in my news feed.
Man, I'm done with social media. All the injustice and brutality going around, and it's like they're trying to suppress our voice. We're trying to get the message out there, and you can't even share empowerment and what's going on around the country either.
Mm-mm. Nah, don't be dumb with social media, though. It's a tool, and there is a place where we have a voice. It's a Let's Buy Black 365 social network. You do anything you would on any other social network. Post pictures, videos, status updates, share resources and community news. But on Let's Buy Black 365, it's a platform for us and by us to tell our messages.
Whoa, that's like a digital underground railroad.
What's the name of that site again?
It's letsbuyblack365.com.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's all about networking, and you get points, right?
Yeah, the more you network, post, and share, the more points you get. Plus, you get points for posting pictures, sharing information, attending community events, and inviting others to network with you on the app.
Wow, that's all I need to know. I'm gonna go download that app right now.
Now, better yet, let me invite you so I can get some points. It's all about empowerment and solutions, y'all.
Yeah, that's what's up. I'm all in.
Let's do it. Let's share our stories.
Let's buy Black365.com.
My uncle died a year before my grandfather. My grandfather died the other day. I can give a mother. If you decide to bob your head to this, family means more to me than dealers to cocaine. I believe that we can be like Kemet. I believe that love will conquer obstacles in this way. Know that. So I'ma keep on making these short story forms in the forms of rap. Walking down the hall away in autumn day. Skipping frolic, I stroll away. That was the day you threw my shit, I broke my locker. Because you had a temper tantrum for some cakes. Your little dimples, when you smile, they turn to wrinkles. After that, we chose not to date again. Your little spoiled ass. I say, I moved to college and I met me a fireball. She had more knowledge than me on the streets. I couldn't accept her features were less than honest. I chose another, she slashed my tires. When I inquired, she looked me dead in my eyes and I knew she was lying. She said she ain't do it. She did it. Check it out. Break it down for a minute. Plenty women been committed to me, but few I revisit. In my mental, mainly rush, I met her. She was earth until I went into my soul and found on Pluto better fit a Mona Mika. Look as flawless as a picture by Picasso. Basquiat, without a doubt, she fits the perfect picture of the perfect missus. Give me the ring so I can kiss her. Come here, baby. I do.
It was a young man who, you know, he wanted to make a lot of money, and so he went to this guru, right? And he told the guru, you know, I want to be on the same level you are. And so the guru said, if you want to be on the same level I'm on, I'll meet you tomorrow at the beach at 4 a.m. He like, the beach? I said, I want to make money. I don't want to swim. Guru said, if you want to make money, I'll meet you tomorrow, 4 a.m. So the young man got there at 4 a.m. He all ready to rock and roll, got on the suit. He should have wore shorts. The old man grabs his hand, said, how bad do you want to be successful? He said, real bad. He said, walk on out in the water. So he walks out into the water. Watch this. When he walks out into the water, it goes waist deep. So he like, this guy crazy. Adrian, he like, I want to make money. He got me out here swimming. I didn't ask to be a lifeguard. I want to make money. He got me in. So he said, come out a little further. Walked out a little further. Then he had it right around this area. He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
And the news reporter says, Jesus is white. She says it with a smile on her face, like it's the most obvious thing in the world. So sure of herself, of her privilege, her ability to change history, rewrite bodies to make them look like her. She says it the same way politicians say racism no longer exists. The same way police officers call dead black boys thugs. The same way white gentrifiers call Brooklyn home. She says it with an American accent, her voice doing that American thing, crawling out of her throat, reaching to clasp onto something that does not belong to her. And I laugh to myself. What makes a black man a black man? Is it a white woman's confirmation? Is it her head nod? Is it the way she's allowed to go on national television and autocorrect the Bible and God himself tell him who his son really
is? Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. All I need is one mic. You know what time it is. Open up your ears. Open up your mind. It's about that time.
About that time.
It's your girl POC. Hey. It's your girl POC.
Hey.
Proof of consciousness. Proof of consciousness.
POC.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind.
All I need is
it's about that.
Yep. You know what time it is, man. We are live right now on reviveisalive.com. Once again, that is reviveisalive.com. Make sure you guys follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at revive_POC. And don't forget to subscribe to both the YouTube channel as well as the newsletter so you can stay locked to everything we got going on here, Revive events such as this one, the 24th annual Lock Conference. We are live broadcasting right now. I got your girl Zarina right here with me. Yo. OZ, what it do? What it do, Z? What a dope. Man, she plays too much. I love being on air with her, man. She plays too much each and every time. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Good afternoon, gentlemen. We are live right now on reviveisalive.com. We're sitting right here next to Maury, the guy with the camera, the one and only guy with the camera. He got the camera equipment, D.
Peace, ladies. Peace. Thank you. Peace.
Audio proofed and all.
Not peace, the audio ladies. Proof.
He wasn't playing.
He wasn't playing at all. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He got you. So what kind of camera equipment do you actually have? Because you got a lot going on. You know what I mean? What you got going on?
Well, I'm usually very, very modest about it. But today I'm going to be really realistic. It's just a basic Nikon
D5600.
I always tell people it's not really the type of sword you have. Mm-hmm. It's how you use your sword.
He called his a sword, Alicia. You know he said he has a sword. He calls his camera a sword.
Yeah,
that was
absolutely.
The first time I heard that one.
Yeah, it's a sword. Because, like, you know, a lot of people, they get these really big cameras, crazy equipment, uh-huh. and then they don't take over nations with it. You know what I mean?
So all the hype, you know what I'm saying, is not necessarily what you need in order to be a good camera woman or a good cameraman. You don't need that.
Absolutely. That's my main thing. Like, of course you want to, depending on what your project is or what you want to aspire to do, you get the right weapon for it. But you don't have to, like, you know, like I said, you know, kingdoms have been brought down by a dagger.
Okay.
One dagger. You know
okay,
what I mean?
I hear so. You. I hear you. So, so you've been walking around, you know what I mean, all day so far. It's only, what, 2:30, so the day hasn't even really gotten, you know, broken into
sure
yet.
Indeed,
there's
sure.
so many different things going on. So what have you seen so far behind the lens?
This is actually my first time at the LOC conference.
Awesome.
I wish I could say I've been here for a lot more of them.
Me too.
But,
me too.
But I will say I've been seeing a lot of, not just community. I'll say like, because you, it's basically when you walk in, you feel it. You know, mm-hmm. it's like there's a lot of commerce going on. There's a lot of connection. There's a lot of building going on. You know, so it's not just about being in a market. It's not just that. It's a lot of connection. And then me like. Being being introduced to the traditionalism, the RBG, and all that stuff, like it's just really interesting to see like all the frequencies of the spectrum. You know what I mean?
All the frequencies of the spectrum. I love what you just said. I love how you ended that one.
Because
there's a lot of frequencies and a lot of vibrations going on here right now, especially with the colors, the patterns, the garbs, the hairdress. Like, it's so many different things going on. So when you speak about frequencies, like, what's the vibe that you're getting right now from this 24th Annual LOC Conference, especially because it's your first one? So what's the vibe that you're picking up?
I'm just getting vibrancy.
Okay.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of vibrancies. Like, it's like I'm seeing real estate people. I'm seeing designers. I'm seeing artists. Yeah. I'm seeing just corporations. I'm seeing a little bit of everything here. You know, a lot of us we're builders. We like to build. We like to create.
But it's so there's a lot parts of parts that go into this. So that's right.
Exactly. So you are seeing a lot of creation, a lot of building, but you're also seeing a lot of the actual like corporate and people with the thought of business and all that behind
it
too.
That's important.
What?
Absolutely.
It's about 500 businesses in here.
Exactly,
you know what I'm saying? And all black owned. Let's give it up.
Absolutely,
you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Speaking of black owned businesses, you're a black owned business owner yourself.
Oh, absolutely. Yes, yes,
you
yes.
know what I'm saying? So before we do, you know, wrap this up, I want you to tell us a little bit about what you do and why, you know, we should also hire you to be the videographer and the photographer, you know, for our upcoming events because we see, you know what I'm saying? We see you doing a great job. So let the people who are listening right now know exactly what you do and how they can stay connected with you.
Well, there are plenty of different ways of doing photography and videography, but my main niche is documenting the process.
Awesome.
And the presentation of art.
We can
or
see you doing that, definitely.
And on the business side of it, I'm more like the guy who makes sure that the other people who have businesses have content.
Okay.
A lot of us, what we have to do is we have to just, we come with our phones and we just doing it ourselves, so it lacks a little bit of that.
Shout out to him for being a great photographer, for understanding that photography and videography is actual content.
Absolutely.
That we, you know what I mean, as hosts need, you know what I mean, or presenters or whoever the event, you know, creator is doing. We need this. Like, it's really important. And a lot of photographers miss that because they have a camera in their hand and they normally shoot from their eye, not exactly, you know, trying to capture the entire environment, you know, everything that's going on.
The process.
That's what he said. And I love it.
Coming out the next time.
And your guy spoke very highly of you as well.
Oh,
so
yeah, Jay Ward,
you definitely
Jay
had somebody
Ward,
invite, you know, vouching for you and everything.
Yeah, you have to have
doing.
Somebody in your corner. You have to have a team, really, or at least that one person in your corner. I mean,
right.
So.
But you was telling us about how we can stay locked with you, you know, and how we can connect with you, if, you know, outside of here.
Yes. There's two things you can do. You can look at the whole collective that I have a team of. It's called the Mercury Collective.
The Mercury Collective.
We're really, really strong on Instagram more than anything.
Okay.
As far as myself, I'm Maury Albright. So my name is Maury Lambright. But as far as Albright, it's
you out here putting
exactly,
out your government name,
right,
Maury.
Right,
you
yeah,
don't
well,
have people
well,
Googling you now.
That's the brand. Yeah.
Oh, well, all right, bad.
I have nothing to hide.
Googling.
Right. You know, I have credits under me, so it's all good.
I'm with it.
But yeah, I'm here actually at the festival with Tahir RGB.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. RBG. So I'm here with him, and that's the whole thing. Like, he needs content. We all need content as creators, as small businesses, as large businesses, as freelancers.
Exactly.
But I also feel like I have to get the whole event. Cause that's how you get the feeling.
Exactly,
you know?
Man. And I appreciate you.
And I do appreciate y'all having me on too.
No
like,
doubt.
This is really cool.
I appreciate
you.
No, for real. And once again, let them know that Instagram so they can stay locked with you again.
So it's Maury Albright, MauryAllbright. That's on Instagram. You could also get me at EPOWXGram on all Instagram right. as well.
Let's oh, go, dope. Man. That's shout out to our guy, Maury. We appreciate you. Thank you for being, you know what I'm saying, engine behind that sword of yours, man. I appreciate I can't wait to see the visuals, you know what I'm saying? Definitely can't wait to see the visuals. And definitely make sure you follow us, too, so we can stay connected, because I'm always looking for, you know, a way to grow and evolve.
Thank you so appreciate you. Ladies.
No doubt. Yo, Z, we about to go to another commercial break. Right after this break, we got another guest coming up who's right here and is ready to speak and listen and talk with us, Z. So let's get ready, man. Yo, Z, shout yourself out. Let the people know how they can find you as well.
Me, Zarina Lomek, on Facebook and Instagram, Zarina Lomek 33, ZARINAHLOMAX, on both aspects, and then 33 on Instagram. And Talking the Walk is the move, and I am here coming in a part of this is T's brand coming in. Yes, this is my girl. She's building this thing and doing her thing for
Revive Radio. We is live, baby. We about to go to no doubt, man. Shout out to Z, always showing love. We about to go to a quick break. We got another guest coming through, man. This is going to be a really quick one, so make sure you guys stay locked. Keep it locked with Meet Your Girl POC. Don't forget to subscribe and definitely follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and also YouTube at Revive_POC.
You are listening to Time For an Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
Are you an entrepreneur? Are you a startup business? Are you a local business? Are you an artist? Are you looking for someone to distribute your content? Revive Radio is the place to be. Come advertise with us at Revive Radio right now. You can find that advertising page at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Advertise with Revive. We are reaching thousands of millennials all across the world. And once again, reviveisalive.com is where you can find that information.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yep, you know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl POC, host of Revive. Today is Winning Wednesday, so you already know each and every Winning Wednesday, we have a jam-packed show for you guys here on Time for the Week. And I need you guys to give us a call right now, 215-490-9832. Once again, that number is 215-490-9832. And you already know, reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com is the place for you to be. Click that link in my bio, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_POC.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time.
About that time.
It's your girl POC.
Yep. You know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive Radio. We are back live once again at the 24th annual Philadelphia Lock Conference, man, going down right now in South Philadelphia, man. If you're missing it, you are definitely missing out. Definitely come and pull up and pop out. Shout out to your boy, Stephon Lamar, for working hard as he does each and every day to support the Revive family. Shout out to your girl, Alicia, as well, for coming through and getting these visuals. Your girl, Z, on the ones and twos, always. Yes. And we got the one and only Bar Muhammad sitting next to me, smelling all good, looking all good. You know, that beautiful smile of yours. How you feeling today, sir?
I feel fine.
You feel fine?
You make me feel better.
Oh, man, don't do that to me. Don't make me smile. I'm trying to make you smile. You making me smile.
There's two people sitting here.
That's I'm just right. saying.
We need two compliments, Mr. Akbar. We need two compliments.
That's right. You definitely got it.
Definitely. Thank you very much.
So how do you feel today, Mr. Akbar?
I feel excellent.
You feel good?
Excellent to be here in Philadelphia at the 24th annual Lox Conference.
Yes.
Unbelievable. Yeah.
Is this your first year?
No, I was here to speak 6 years ago.
Awesome.
I thought it was 3 years ago. She said it was 6 years
ago.
time is flying. I can agree with you on that one.
I was impressed. Then I told my family about it because, you know, it's something that should spread across the country.
Mm-hmm.
And the energy that I felt from the brothers and sisters who were here.
Yeah.
And it represents consciousness.
Yes, know, yes.
In terms of our roots, our culture. And it's bring a level of consciousness to the hair business and mm-hmm. so forth, and the look of where we came from.
Uh-huh.
So I really appreciate it.
I appreciate you for coming. Yeah. And when you said you spoke, you were here to present 6 years ago, what did you actually present 6 years ago? Because I know today you're here about your book, to talk about your book.
6 years ago, I talked about Africa. I lived in, my book is about my 12 years that I lived in Africa.
Wow.
And in those, and I lived in the country of Ghana and West Africa. And I came to talk about it to encourage young people in particular to travel to Africa.
I actually just went myself.
Have you been to Africa?
I just went. I came back in May. I was there for 30 days. I had the blessing of going to Nigeria, and that's the country. And then the state was Ogun State. And then the city that I lived in was Abeokuta. Abeokuta, yes.
Excellent.
So I was a little bit under the rock. I was in the village. I didn't get a chance. I didn't even get a chance to see Lagos. I was in Lagos for about maybe 3 to 4 hours, and it was so crowded and so overwhelming. I was so ready to go.
Right.
I have none of these stories. I've been to the African market. I've gotten some fish. That's about all I got for you.
But you've never been to Africa.
No, but I always wanted to go.
Okay. But first, I want to say that you look like a sister's from Mali.
Ooh.
Really? I always get them as Somalian. They do ask me that. Uh-huh. Or Ethiopian.
Ethiopian.
Yeah.
But the southern part of Ethiopia, mainly.
Uh-huh.
But more Mali, Bamako, and
okay.
even...
He's telling you your roots, baby. You only need to go on Ancestry.com. You good. Mr. Muhammad got you.
So I can get to Africa.
That's right.
Yes.
But the important thing about your travel to Africa, it can change your life, number one.
Yeah.
It's an investment in memory. Whatever money you put out mm-hmm. to travel to Africa, it's something that will live with you. You'll never mm-hmm. shake it. And the beautiful thing about going to Africa, because we hear so many negative stories about mm-hmm. Africa, is when you look in the face of people.
Mm-hmm.
You look at them and you...
I'm looking at yours right now.
You can actually figure out where they came from, you know, after you travel around the continent. You went to Nigeria, 191 million people
mm-hmm.
in Nigeria.
Really?
It's a country that
I'm Igbo. I'm part of the Igbo tribe.
Did you go to the north at all?
No.
Like Kano and...
I went to Abuja.
Abuja.
And I went to... what's next to Abuja?
Did you go to Ife, Odon State?
No. Ogun, Abuja, and it was one more. It was Abeokuta, Abuja. I can't think of it right now. It's slipping my mind.
And so have you done?
They named me when I was out there. My name is Eniola.
Is that right?
What's your name? Akbar.
But, you know, in West Africa,
Akbar.
There's at one of the tables right here, the table where I'm autographed in my book, they have what is called day names. And it's very popular in West Africa, especially Ghana.
Okay.
Because most of us don't know what day of the week. There's seven names for seven
women
and seven males.
I know that, yes.
And if you were born on a Tuesday,
your name
will
be named Tuesday.
Because I know that I was born on a
mm-hmm.
Tuesday, and it's Kwabena.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
My best friend was born on a Friday, and her name is Ifia.
Ifia, see?
Yep.
And they're actually day names.
Your mommy give me none of this information.
But most people don't know what day they were born on.
Exactly.
Do you know what day you were born on before you went to Africa?
No.
See?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know
a lot about myself until I went to Africa, to be honest with you.
But, you know, to look into yourself, because for years since we've been here, there's been this disconnect from Africa.
Yeah.
They never connected us to Africa. Even when Martin Luther King went to Africa, which most black Americans don't know anything about. Did you know that Martin Luther King went to Africa?
No.
I did not know. I knew Malcolm did, but I didn't know Martin did.
I never knew that. They didn't put that in the story.
That's right.
That's why we need to do our own
And you have to wonder why.
That's right.
Because the children on King's birthday, they celebrate King, they read his speech and so forth. But I have not been to one celebration where they said Martin Luther King went to Africa and he was inspired by Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So he went March the 6th, 1957.
Okay. What part did he go to?
He went to Ghana.
Okay.
He went on the occasion of Ghana's independence. And I've been fighting that we should include it in the curriculum, which you talk about.
Absolutely.
Because he wrote a speech on his return that he delivered April the 7th, 1957 at Dexter Street Baptist Church that he was the pastor of on his return. And when you read the speech, you see how Africa inspired him.
Absolutely.
And he wanted to see us get involved in Africa.
I love
it. So when you do your shows and talk about it, especially when King's birthday comes up, King's trip to Africa that brought him to a certain level of consciousness.
Did he write about that? I would love to read what he said.
You could read that speech. I don't know for sure whether it's in one of his books.
I'm going to look for that.
But look it up.
Because I like Martin Luther King.
And it will inspire you. The next thing, I just want to say this quickly. If you go to Africa, I encourage, not because I lived in Ghana for 12 years, but I encourage people to go to Ghana for the slave dungeons alone.
So see what it looks like?
To go through the slave dungeons and listen to the history of how the slaves were captured, brought from the interior, put in these dungeons until ships arrived. And they were from different areas, different groups, different tribes, so they all couldn't speak the language. How they were fed in the slave dungeon. Mm. All of this is very important for our young people to see.
I think it's very important.
I'm with you on that.
I listened to the news here in Philly last night.
Where are you from? You keep saying here in Philly. So what did you travel from? You keep saying here in Philly. What did you travel from?
I traveled here from Atlanta. I'm from New York, but I live
But you live in Atlanta. Awesome.
Okay. But I live in Atlanta now.
How was that travel? We were just talking about Atlanta.
Atlanta.
He lives in Atlanta. Mr. Akbar lives in Atlanta.
Is that right? Okay. Well, we got to hook up when you get to Atlanta, okay?
So what would you say? Because we didn't hear such great things about Atlanta.
Well, hold on. Let's finish this quick interview. We live, baby. We live right quick. He's trying to get to Atlanta. He's trying to figure it out. We're going to let him figure that out. But, Mr. Akbar, you were finishing what you were saying. You were saying that before anything happens, you were saying that you encourage the kids to go to Africa because of the dungeons, and you were saying we need to go see the dungeons.
Right. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, who you know well, worked on this Stop the Killing. And our young people killing each other in the streets of America.
Yes, they are.
And when Minister Farrakhan went to Africa, Ghana, he visited the slave dungeon. And what we talked about is young people being taken there. And they say, well, why? What does it mean? It means that you have to know how you ended up in America. Mm-hmm. Very important.
Definitely. And that's why you're writing this book right here?
That's what the book is about.
Okay.
I love it.
Aspects in Africa. But in order to do something today, you have to know where you came from.
That's
a fact. You got
to
know
your family. And in order to go somewhere, you got to know where you're coming from. You know what I'm saying? And then you can't forget about where you go once you get there, too.
Yes.
A lot of people forget about it once they get there, though, Mr. Akbar.
But, you know, they forget about it because it's not a study lesson that's taught in school.
Yeah, I don't even remember. None of that stuff was taught to me in school.
Do you go to public school or private
school? I went to public school.
Oh, you go to public school? Okay.
Did you go to public school?
I went to public school in New York.
Okay.
And there's one thing that I found consistent. They taught you about George Washington, Abraham Lincoln. Mm-hmm. You went to school in Philly. You went in Philly?
No, Washington, D.C.
Washington. I went to New York. But it was a study diet of the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
But there's nobody giving us a study diet of our history,
Our
being coming to America, being made slaves on a plantation.
You want to hear this though, Ms. Akbar? They are giving us a story about history, but they're giving us a story about history. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
basically, the Gregorian way, just like it's a Gregorian calendar, which is not really. I ain't even gonna get into it, but y'all know.
Exactly. Yeah, sure. But I want to ask you a couple questions about the book. So the book is entitled Africa and the World. So when it comes to Africa and the world, would you say that Africa is kind of sort of left out when you talk about the world, when you talk about things that's going on around the world? Because even when it comes to like trade and economics, when it comes to agriculture, we don't really mention Africa, and Africa has the most richest soil on this planet, so when it comes to agriculture and also economics, I feel like Africa can help, but it's always left off. So what's your views on that?
You're absolutely correct. She's correct, because the president's wife just went to Africa.
Okay.
She's visiting four countries. Now, the first thing that black Americans need to ask, why is she going to Africa?
Right.
What is that all about?
Is it about? Right.
well, the Chinese have made a move on Africa and is digging wealth out of Africa and so forth. I don't blame the Chinese, but they had a conference in China with African leaders at the first part of September.
Okay.
And the Chinese had pledged over the next, I believe it is 10 years, $60 billion invested in Africa. So America is being left out.
Yeah.
And being that, that Trump said that Africa was an asshole, I don't know if you all heard about that, but he was meeting with African leaders last year at the UN, and he called Africa an asshole.
Uh-huh.
And then, so
go ahead
African,
and say it. Go ahead and say it. What's the asshole? What that stand for?
What
does the asshole stand for?
It stands for a shithole.
Go ahead and say it. You know what I'm saying? You old enough. Let me check your ID. You old enough? Can you say it for real, Mr. Akbar? Don't be acting all scared.
Okay.
Speak your truth, brother. That's why we here. Speak your truth. If Donald Trump can say it, you can say it. He ain't bite his tongue.
I mean, then when his staff told him how dangerous that was because of what they need and what they depend on Africa for, so now with China making this move, all of a sudden he sends his wife.
And when the Chinese make a move, it's a move.
And that's right.
You know, that they make moves.
And so the first place she went, you know, the first place that she went was Ghana. And in Ghana, she went to the slave dungeon. So when Black America sits and looks at that, I wonder what goes through their mind.
But the crazy part is his wife is not even American.
I mean,
she's still from a whole nother foreign country herself.
Right. That's right. She's an immigrant. Like, he's trying to drive all of the immigrants out.
Exactly.
And he got,
and your wife and your child.
Exactly. Exactly.
So we know by his language. We know by his cabinet.
Yeah.
Got one Black man in the whole cabinet who looks like a fly in buttermilk, Ben Carson.
Ben Carson. We just talked about him yesterday.
Someone who his history classes. So what we have to look at, why is this push on Africa right now? So we want to get our people involved in their own culture. We want them to use their knowledge to contribute to Africa, to travel back and forth. And even if we set up some kind of land base in the Caribbean and Africa where Black people can have this experience, to me, it's very, very important.
I think that's very important.
Very important.
So, and does it talk about this in the book, where we going to meet up and how we going to meet up, the time, the date, the place, the location?
Okay. Well,
because I know it's some secrets in this book.
Okay. what it is that I'm going to speak in the book Roundtree.
Okay.
And I'm going to be signing books. So I want to make sure that both of you get a book. Okay?
Please do.
I want to leave at 3.
At 3?
Yeah, so okay. We'll look at God because it's 2:57.
Okay, listen.
We're going to make sure.
Leroy, go get me a book, okay, another book.
Thank you, Brother Leroy. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
I want to give. But thank you very much.
And but I want you to tell us just a little bit smidget of what you're going to be talking about at the book roundtable too.
Okay, at the book roundtable, I have a map of Africa up on the wall.
Oh wow!
I'm gonna talk about Africa and Liberia in particular, because in 1823 they sent slaves back to Africa, and these slaves went because they didn't want to remain slaves in America, and they developed the country of Liberia.
Awesome.
I'm definitely going to talk about that. Then I'm going to talk about names, because all of the young hip-hop brothers who take Italian names, it bothers me.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody need to tell them, you are not Italians.
Yes.
Those Italians do not love you.
Mm-hmm.
And why would you call yourself Gucci Mane or John Gotti? Those are you don't have enough sense
to
take an African name or something that represents where you came from.
And who you are.
You're taking white Italians and you live in Philadelphia. You know how they feel about
that's
you.
Exactly.
And what you look like running around and you proud of Black mafia family and all of that. It's stupidity. It's because they're not conscious.
Yep.
They need someone to help them. And
exactly.
This is not a dig. You did it out of ignorance. But once you get knowledge, you say, hell no, I'm not no John Gotti. John Gotti didn't love no Black folks. He came from New York. I know the area in New York. That's where Al Sharpton got stabbed by those same Italians you naming yourself as.
Exactly.
So we got to make them grow up.
Exactly. Okay. But also, by you mentioning, you know, Al Sharpton, I don't want to get you started because you probably got a lot you can say on Al Sharpton. But we need more leaders, you know what I mean, such as yourself. So I appreciate you writing books like this. But we need more leaders, because you mentioned Martin, we mentioned Malcolm, we mentioned, you know, Al Sharpton. But it's like right now in 2018, you know, we need to be calling for more leaders. So right. When you do get on the platforms that you want, because you are such a powerful man, you know what I mean, your word travels so far. I really want you to call on to the young people to speak up and stand up as the leaders that we need. It's your job to do that, sir. I'm serious. Okay. Because you have more knowledge and wisdom than we do, you know, so you got to put that into us.
Okay, let me say this. That's, you know, Minister Farrakhan went on the Breakfast Show.
The Breakfast Club. Look at him. Okay.
And on there, his objective was to inspire young brothers for leadership.
Yeah.
Don't just use your fame, you know. I think about Lil Wayne. Mm-hmm. Every time he goes to jail and come out, they got full-page ad. Yeah, he's going to perform so-and-so.
Uh-huh.
But use that position and influence to help lead young black people, talk to them and tell them that I made some mistakes. Don't make those mistakes.
That is
I'm
with
you. Know, do something different because your people need help.
That's right.
I'm with you. I appreciate you for coming through. I definitely appreciate you for talking to us and also giving us one of the books. I really appreciate it because I'm actually going to read it for real. But how can they stay connected with you? How can they purchase your books for everybody who's listening right now?
Well, there is a phone number. I'm going to. If you like, if you would like to get a book, or if you would like to invite me to speak, you can call 678-549-4775.
Don't look up that number.
That's 678-549-4775. Tell you how to order a book. Tell you how I can come to your city and talk about these
and
things.
And he also has an email as well on there, which is Akbar, which is spelled AKBAR at cousin, COUSIN, trips, TRIPS.com. So make sure you guys hit him up in his email as well. He has a lot of things going on. He's on a tour date as well. He got a lot of things going on. Yeah. So shout out to you,
cousin
Mr. Akbar.
Trip is where we take people to Africa.
Yeah, you see,
I love it. That's what I'm saying. We want to make sure they hit that email so they can get to Africa. You know, Z, that was for you. That was the plug. But Z is actually about to get out of here, so I definitely want you to give yourself a shout out, Z. Tell the people how they can find you. You got some things coming up as well, October 14th. Shout it out. Let the people know once again. Thank you, Z. I appreciate
you for coming through and rocking.
I'm meeting me today.
So next Sunday, again, it is a fashion show that I'm having, October 14th. Revive Radio will be in the house, and they will be on, they'll be doing interviews such as today. And it is a fashion show at 2600 North 5th Street. Live performances, live interviews. By designers, just fashion and music coming together.
Save the
so
date.
Make sure you are in the place. That is also a scene when we talk about gun violence that is going to be dedicated to slain victims. So you'll be able to meet the parents and come up to them and meet them. And also, like I said to you, you can follow me, Zarina Lomax, 33 on Instagram, and Zarina Lomax on Facebook, and like the page Talking the Walk Philly and watch the movement and keep up with Revive Radio.
No doubt, man. Z, once again, I appreciate you for coming through. Thank you for blessing us here at Revive Radio, man. We're about to go to a quick break. After this break, we got some more guests lined up as well. Shout out to Stefan Lamar, man. He's around here running around somewhere like a chicken with his head cut off for Revive Radio, man. I love it, man. Shout out to all these locks that's walking in the building. I mean, the locks are on fire. It's making me want to start over for real and do it the right way this time, man. But you already know what time it is. It's Meet Your Girl POC. Thank you, Mr. Akbar.
I appreciate you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Okay.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me. Ooh, 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 ooh. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free. Feel.
fly out in the sun. You know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun. You know what I mean? Sleep in peace when day is done. That's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me. Stars, when you shine, you know how I feel. Scent of the pine, you know how I feel. The freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new
There's a lot of mental suffering. You know, there are mental sufferings that are inherited through DNA, but then there's mental suffering that occurs after 200 and 300 years of brutal oppression. You know, you just go a little crazy, and nobody should be surprised. So a lot of what has to happen with people under oppression is a great deal of discipline. You know, if you meditate, there's a way in which things do line up. You know, it's a wonderful way to put yourself in order. If it's not meditation, you know, it can be dancing, it can be painting, it can be writing. But there has to be some way to keep a healthy soul, you know, to keep a real centered part of yourself that is not touched, is not overrun by the oppression that you encounter on a daily basis.
I am not black. I mean, that's what the world calls me, but it's not me. I didn't come out of my mother's womb saying, "Hey, everybody, I'm black." No, I was taught to be black. And you were taught to call me that, along with whatever you call yourself. It's just a label. See, from birth, the world force feeds us these labels. And eventually, we all swallow them. We digest and accept the labels, never ever doubting them. But there's one problem. Labels are not you, and labels are not me. Labels are just labels. But who we truly are is not skin deep. See, when I drive my car, no one would ever confuse the car for me. Well, when I drive my body, why do you confuse me for my body? It's my body. Get it? Not me. Let me break it down. See, our bodies are just cars that we operate and drive around. The dealership we call society decided to label mine.
Yep. You know what time it is, man. It's me, your girl, POC, host of Revive Radio. We are back live right now on reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. I got your boy, Stephon Lamar, back on the mic with me.
Yes,
you know
yes,
what I mean? You've been running around all morning.
Right.
Running around all morning.
This has been amazing. This is my first conference. Well, all of our first conference.
Yes. You know, 24th annual LOC conference going down right now in the city of Philadelphia, man. Shout out to, you know, everyone who put this event together. Everyone who... Like, it's so much black excellence in the building.
Right, yeah.
So much black excellence in the building. We got one of the vendors with us here as well. Sean, get up into the mic. What's up? Get up into the mic.
What going on? What going on? And, you know, just a little disclaimer. I'm from Barbados. I'm from Barbados.
Okay.
The West Indies. So our greeting is we say, what going on?
What's going on?
What going on?
What going on? What going on?
Yeah, there it is. There it is.
Okay, so I just came back from Haiti. I just came back from Haiti last week. Well, 2 weeks ago. It was Sapaste.
Yeah,
I'm learning my little, you know, Creole, whatever. I'm getting out here. I'm cultured.
Right.
But what about what's going on in Barbados though? Like, what's going on right now in Barbados that we should know about?
Oh, you mean as far as the entertainment scene?
Yeah, because I ain't been to Barbados, and all I know is about Riri. You know what I mean? She make it look so lavish.
Yeah, did you hear about her becoming the ambassador? For
yes.
Barbados? He did pull that out.
You know what's funny? So I
shout out to you doing your research, baby.
There it is. Even though I'm from Barbados, I came over here in 93.
Okay.
And I didn't go back to Barbados till 2012.
Okay.
So in a weird way, I'm like a tourist.
Okay.
So I went back.
Way to keep it funky. Way to keep it funky.
Just to be honest, so I went back this year and I saw the Rihanna Drive. Like there's a big plaque. Like a
as it should be.
Tall plaque.
Oh, wow. As it should
and
be.
And I was cheesy. I took a picture with it. It was like, ah. So I'm just as much of a tourist.
So you went home and did some tourist stuff is pretty much what you're saying.
Yes,
you
went home
to do some tourist stuff. But what I wanted to say to you too is shout out to these beautiful locks that you have. Yeah. Oh, why are you covering them though? Why do you have a scarf around? It's a lock conference. Why ain't let them, you know, the roots breathe?
Yeah, well, actually.
Well, he on his move. Let me answer that for you. Okay. He on his move. He's telling us stuff. He ain't trying to be worrying about his hair. He probably could have got it done up and tied up, but you know, it was a little quick style for him.
Right,
you know?
Right.
Like, yeah, and it looks good.
It's also a thing too. My loctician advised me sometimes about being like around a lot of people. Our hair is our antenna, and sometimes I'm in a state
that's
right now
gem.
From traveling, coming back, because I was in Guyana, then I was in Barbados, and I came back here.
Mm.
So I'm going through like a transition. So it's almost a sort of a protection. Like I'm making sure that I'm good. And containing, you know what I mean? So I didn't want to pick up
the crazy part is I thought I was the only weirdo, right?
Yes.
So look, I do the exact same thing, but I don't do mine while I'm here. I actually do mine while I'm traveling. When I'm traveling, I have a scarf around my locks. I don't play. I don't care. I don't need your air. I don't need your dust. I don't need nothing.
Mm.
When it comes to my hair, it's like really like my truth, my journey. It's like really a call. My hair is really like part of me. So when I'm out and I'm in all and about, like the entire time when I was in Nigeria, I wore a scarf every day or some kind of a wrap almost every day, and they looked at me like I'm like you, like why don't I let my hair down? I'm like, nope, not gonna happen, just not gonna happen. So I thought I was the only one that thought like that.
Yeah,
so that's really exciting.
My locticians really gave me, because I'm kind of new to locks. Before locks, I had braids actually,
okay,
so they're really long. So,
oh, so you had the little bow wows, you had the
yeah, yeah, you know, but then I was like, you know, I'm getting old now, I don't want to be just out here rocking cornrows and stuff. So that's why my locks, people are like, you know, how long have you been growing your locks? But it's only like 3 years,
really, because you had hair regardless,
right? So she's really, shout out to Awena, Empress Awena, too. That's my loctician. So she's really like giving me a lot of the background and culture and knowledge about locks. And I felt like coming back, I wanted to make sure that I was good and wasn't giving off any negative energy. And it's so funny because you don't know Stephon. I'm pointing like people can see, but Stephon, that talk that you gave me today, that I needed that.
Really?
You know what I mean? I wasn't quite all
we wasn't
the way
a part
there
of the talk, so tell us about the talk.
He was just talking about the law of attraction.
Awesome. Okay.
And
he actually
blessings.
Just said that too. When he came, he was saying that he wanted to say something to me, but he didn't want to say something because somebody had already said something to me about what he was going to say. So then he didn't say anything to me, and then the universe brought him right back to me.
Yo, it's crazy. You know what I mean? So I really needed that talk, so thank you so much, brother, for that. And now I feel in a better space now to give more positive energy.
Well, to give you a little piggyback on what you were just saying, Stefan is live every Monday through Friday.
All right.
He actually has something called the Attender Circle, where you can actually get a little bit more about that each and every day.
Doing
you know
big
what I'm saying?
Each and every day. All right.
Yes.
Well, that's what's up. Let's get into hieroglyphics, man.
Okay.
Oh, my, yo. Sean, I wish we could, well, if you go on our IG Live, you'll see the snaps of some of his pieces. He is exceptional.
Thank you.
He is an exceptional artist. Let's talk about that for a little bit. Like,
appreciate that.
Why you started and your comic book you have coming out, the name of that, and what's the basis, the tell all behind your comic book and why you brought it out.
Okay.
Why you bringing it out.
So, I mean, we could go back to when from being a
shout
a
out
kid,
to a black owned comic book. We
right
need
on,
that.
Right on.
And a black owned comic book writer. We need that. And an illustrator. We need that too.
We do. We do need more of that. So, I grew up in Barbados. And the beautiful thing about Barbados is that we're surrounded by Nubian people, right? It's like all faces, most of the faces look like men, like mine. But the problem being, I never had anybody to put me on the path of draw what's around you, right?
Right.
So, America, even though some people, you know, there's a lot of conflict and there's a lot of negativity that people talk about America. One of the beautiful things about America is that there is so much diversity and that people, they encourage you to support your diversity, right? So it wasn't until I came to America and I met other Nubian artists that were drawing comic books and they say, Sean, your art is good, but where's the black people?
Ooh.
It wasn't until then that it hit me and I was like, I was only creating what I saw, which were Caucasians and Asians.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And that got me really into creating Nubian people. And that got me thinking about then Afrofuturism and seeing
Afrofuture. You made that up because I can't even pronounce that. I can't recite that. One more time for the people who try and say it again. What you say?
Afrofuturism. And I guess
Afrofuturism.
Exactly. So seeing Africa in the future. And so many times in pop culture, comic books, movies, video games, you don't see a lot of Nubian people represented. Mm-hmm. And if you do see us, it's always, most times it's in a derogative light. So Afrofuturism is about putting Nubian people in a more positive spin.
Make sure you put that in a dictionary, okay?
I can't take the credit for
it. And right under, just need to say Sean.
Yeah, it goes.
This is a little sidebar, but just corroborating what you just said, Naruto is popping because we were talking about how popular it is.
Right.
But how do you feel about Killer B? Because me and my friend were talking about how
they over here having boys talk.
He's a rapper. Why is that? He's a rapper.
We're going to have a little moment here.
Yeah, I can tell.
You know, because my friend told me about it, and I was like, well, I didn't think much about him being a rapper.
Mm-hmm.
But he's like, well, he's black and he's a rapper. Why is that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so what do you think about that? Do you think it's like some hidden connotation behind it, or is it just like what they felt like would be fun as a cartoon character? Like for him to be a rapper, like, it's nothing behind it.
No, here's the thing, right? You gotta realize that Nubian people are one of the most idealized, envied people on the planet.
Right.
It's just that nobody wants to be one, right?
Right.
So I don't blame the Asian people for, you know, absorbing Nubian culture, especially American culture and rapping, and wanting to emulate that, but just not knowing how.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Okay.
So a lot of the characters, you look at, what's the guy from Dragon Ball Z?
Right,
you know, one of the most horrible, stereotypical, derogative examples of a Nubian person that you will find, but they don't know any better. That's
right,
why
right.
It's so important that when us as Nubian people, if you're in that field, art, whatever you're doing, art, music, visual,
okay.
You know what I mean? Terrible, right?
Yeah.
I hope everybody listening can follow along because I feel like y'all just talking to yourselves.
Well, go check it out.
Check it out.
Those are very popular cartoons. You know?
What's the name of the cartoon again?
Naruto and Dragon Ball Z Dragon Ball GT.
Yeah, and some of the examples of Nubian people, and when I say Nubian, I mean black, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the examples in these cartoons and anime are very stereotypical is because they're created by somebody else. That's why it's so important for me that if I'm creating my own character,
right.
It has to go deeper and not just color, represent a heritage, a culture. It has to mean something, you know
right.
what I mean? And be seen in a positive light. So, right. you know, as Killer B, he's a fun character. I don't blame him for going that route, but I do see that they don't know any better.
Right.
That's what it is.
Right.
Well, let's get back to Afro. Yeah. One more time.
Afrofuturism.
Afrofuturism.
The greatest example of that you will see is probably Black Panther.
Okay.
That is the most popular example right now of Afrofuturism.
Okay.
So what it is basically about seeing us Nubian people in a positive futuristic light. So my story is called Sep Credo.
Okay.
Sep Credo.
SEP-KRADO. And is an amalgam of two words. It basically translates to knife of justice.
Mm.
And in this world, people are going to be able to tap into Adinkra symbols. and control the properties.
I love
properties.
An anchor symbol. Yeah, I have one tatted on my body, actually.
That's
wait
a beautiful.
Until, yeah. Yo, we have to go over to his table.
His table,
and
okay.
Check out the picture.
Thank you.
Oh, wait, so do you have a whole book already for the...
So it's in the works right now. It's in development. And the thing was, I do full-time freelance work, and sometimes I have so many clients and so many pieces I'm working on. I don't get to draw my stuff.
Okay. Please don't say you do full-time freelance work. Say you are a full-time entrepreneur.
A full-time entrepreneur.
Exactly.
So a lot of times, the entrepreneur life, you got to do
stuff.
Because
I'm sure you ain't lancing around. I'm sure you out here working. Please
exactly.
Don't say you out here freelancing.
So we're working. Sometimes you got to do things that pays the bills.
I'm with
and
you.
My own personal projects sometimes get put to the back burner. Mm-hmm. So this guy here me up and say, Sean, I really love your work. I want to do a solo art show. Come down with some concepts. Yeah. So I took the concept to him and I was like, this may not be your thing, but I want to do an Afrofuturist art gallery. And he said, I love it. So it fast tracked the concept. And basically the concept is based on a historical event, one of the Kendake of Meroway, the African queen. Mm-hmm. She fought Alexander the Great using these war elephants. So I said, what if I took that story and did a sci-fi twist to it? Mm. So instead of war elephants, like in the future, she has these tanks. They're able to tap into Dinkra symbols, and then they control these giant African mechas. So all the things we grew up on,
right.
Like Gundam and even Transformers, these giant mecha robots, but you don't see us, Nubian
right.
people, reflected in these concepts. So that's
so,
what we need to do. I was
so
just talking
like
about
a,
you.
A mix between the Boondocks and Transformers. Boondocks, Transformers, and Dragon Ball Z all put into one cartoon.
Yo, I might have to steal that, Stefan. Right. I love that. That's
so,
nice.
Girl, you think you're excited now just hearing about it. Wait until you actually see the drawings.
I got to get into it. But I want to ask you this question before we wrap up a little bit. So when it comes to, because you said you want to put, a black character out there. You want to create, positive, action figures as well as characters that surround, people that look like us.
Yes.
But what about for, platforms who are already doing that? Do you think that's a little bit of culture appropriation? Such as, could you say one of the films that just recently did it was Black Panther,
right.
But a lot of people was giving a lot of pushback to Black Panther because it's still owned by Disney,
right.
And it still was written by a white man. However you think about it. So what do you think about Black Panther is owned by a white company and it was written by a white man. Coming from a black perspective,
yeah.
Technically.
We're kind of just talking about this when we were talking about Naruto and Dragon Ball Z.
Right.
About how, they can't help to kind of, not appropriate, but they can't help to give their rendition or what they see, what they observe.
Yeah.
But do you think, I think what Pac is asking you, do you feel like it's from a, not negative, but is it enough given the fact that it's a white person doing it? Do you feel like we can look at it and take ourselves from it given that, it's from a different perspective.
No, you took the words right out of my head because what I'm going to say is that I have
y'all
no
just
problem.
Better known each other before today.
It's
y'all just
so.
Best buddies over here. Y'all just better know
you
each
took
other.
The words straight out because once again, Black Panther was created by white people. I have no problem with that. My problem is when where it stops. So all the people that are now screaming out Afrofuturism and you went to see Black Panther and your daishikis and you now all of a sudden you're rocking your bees. That's cool. What happens next? Go out here and look for the other people that are creating Afrofuturist stories, that are creating their own
right.
stories featuring Nubian characters. Support them as well. Don't just put the money into Disney and keep pumping it back into Marvel.
Right.
You know what I mean? If that's
right.
a gateway, that's cool. I'm getting real passionate right now.
Right.
But if that's a gateway, that's cool, but it can't stop there. So that's my main issue. I don't have a problem with Disney and Marvel, taking these characters and putting them into the forefront. In Disney, Wonder Woman, a lot of people don't know that. Wonder Woman has a twin sister called Nubia. And
I don't
was,
know that. I don't
was,
know that. Drop gems for one time.
I'm dropping these jewels.
Dropping gems for one
jewels
time.
On you.
Wait, she has a, wait, say it again?
So she has a twin sister called Nubia that debuted back in 1976. The whole story is so ridiculous. She was made, but she was taken to this secret island and hidden away for all these years. She came back to fight Wonder Woman for the throne. Of course,
this
lost.
Was in the comic book
this
or
is
in the
movie?
This
in the actual comic book.
Oh, in the
now,
comic
what
book.
Said
okay.
That they're going to do, of course, with the popularity of Black Panther, is that she's supposed to be in the second movie.
Okay.
Tiffany Haddish was auditioning for the role.
Really?
So we'll see, but...
He really out here dropping gems. He probably talking about some stuff. Hey, he's fucking nuts. Yeah.
Sprinkling what? Gems on you. Look, I got the Infinity Gauntlet on me. I don't know if you caught that. That's for my comic book people. people.
I'm with it. Does comic book still, you know what I'm saying, thrive right now in 2018? Like, are people still going to get comic books?
Or are they, like, digitalized or anything?
Well, the comic book industry is so huge right now. The main reason I started going back to Barbados in 2012 is because they have a comic book convention over there. When I left in 93, it was almost like this whole, like, oh, that's, you know, that was a separate life. I'm starting this new life in America. And my mom said in 2012, she said, Sean, you know, there's a comic book convention in Barbados. I said, what? Shut up, mom. You know what I'm talking about. I didn't actually tell her that.
I was about to say, I know you did. She would have sucked them teeth so hard.
But, you know, so I contacted the guy that is the head of it, and we spoke. I said, I'm a Barbadian, you know, that I'm a comic book artist. They flew me in, put me up in a hotel, took care of me. I've been going back every year, and every year it's been growing. This is the next year with the 10th year they're doing it, and it is one of the best conventions ever. First of all, it's a convention in Barbados.
What do you see when
you
get there, though?
So here's the thing. Here was the other leg of my artistic journey. I told you that I was drawing nothing but Caucasian, Asian people. Then in America, I changed, and they opened my eyes to drawing Nubian people. In Barbados, when I went back, these guys are creating characters based in Barbadian folklore.
Yes.
Another level that I didn't even think about being Barbadian. Of like, yo, there's all these levels to the and areas to the diaspora. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? So it's not just African
and people
want to
know, and people want to know about it.
Yes,
we want to know about it because not many people are able to travel to Barbados.
Exactly.
You know, so to be able to give us the literature and the vision, you know what I mean, and the views all at the same time is amazing. Yeah. You know what I mean? Because pictures say 1,000 words.
Yeah, and same here. No, like I meet so many people, young and old, that say, Sean, always wanted to draw, always wanted to do my own comic, but I've been scared. I don't know. I think you know what's crazy? So one of the characters in Sep Credo, right?
Okay,
the father. I wanted to create like this, you know, strong, you know, visually powerful black character, right?
Okay.
This guy, I told about the story. He said, Sean, I have an investor for you, and he's from Africa. I said, well, that's amazing. That's perfect, right? Perfect mix. I had a meeting with the guy. The first thing the guy said, he said, Sean, I love this concept.
I love your
shirt. We should make the main character white.
I love your shirt.
And I said,
the main character who?
White, Caucasian. And I said, why? And he said, because, you know, Sean, we got to think bigger. We got to think about universal appeal.
Mm.
I was so angry, right? As soon as I got home, first of all, I said, no, I'm good. I left the meeting.
Ooh.
And then I got home and I did
something.
Don't sell
out, black man. I appreciate you for that.
Where I did something where the more the character uses his powers, the darker he gets. Like, I wanted to, I was so enraged by this African man telling me that we have to make these characters white for universal appeal. So my job now, even though, like I said, I draw a lot of different things. So in my book, you will see a Wonder Woman. You might see a Captain America. But if I'm creating something for myself, I feel I have a responsibility to other Nubian people and the next generation to create what's in the mirror and something that we can be proud of. So
I got one last question for you. I know you and Stefan can go all day. So let me get my one question in real quick. So when it comes to you actually being here today at the 24th annual Law Conference, and you know what I mean, you putting, you know, together a collection of your art, how do you see your art actually being a part of the conference? You know, when you first envisioned yourself being a vendor for here, how did you see your art actually being a part of the conference? Because it says Law Conference, you know, so people are coming here, you're thinking about, you know, shea butter, hair jewelry, all the things that deal with hair, but then you come as an actual artist, a visual artist. How did you see yourself fitting in today's conference?
Well, you know, I don't know how much time you got. I'm going to give you a little quick story. I'll give you a quick story, right? So back when I was now starting to do this full time, I met with this guy. We were working on a project, right? Things went south, and I'll never forget, right? After he disappeared for like 2 weeks, he came back. He called me. He had owed me some money. We were supposed to finish up some stuff, all that. He called me. He said, hey, what's up, Sean? I say, hey, man, you know, I didn't hear from you in 2 weeks. What's going on? These were his exact words. He said, let me tell you something, Sean. I've only ever had to shoot 2 people in my life. I said, what? He said, I'm not going to work with you anymore. I'm going to take this concept. I'm going to change it so you don't own anything. And I'm going to go my way and you go yours. Then he proceeded to say, Sean, you know what your problem is? You're scared of success. If I could draw like you, there'd be nothing stopping me. I listened to everything he said.
If I could draw like you, it would be nothing stopping me.
Nothing stopping me from taking over the world.
Mm-hmm.
I listened to everything this man said. I got off the phone with him, and I said, I'm going to do everything it takes in my power to never have to work for somebody else again in that capacity.
Facts.
I went online. I looked at all the areas where maybe there might be art. I saw an ad for the LOTS conference. This was like 5 years ago. I called up Mama Okosua over there.
Yes, yes.
I didn't have the money on me. I said, sis, I just found out about your convention. Is there any way I could get a table there? I could pay you half now, half next week. She said, no problem. I went to her house, gave her the money. Next week, gave her the rest. I set up. I told myself, if I do the LOTS conference, I bet you that everybody there is going to be selling incense, shea butter, all the stuff you just said. I bet you I'm going to be the only artist here. And sure enough, I was. Killed it that first. I was outside. That was back when they were doing outside as well in the parking lot. We were someplace else. It wasn't here. And set up, and I killed it. And I've been back ever since. Because as Nubian people, one of the things I love about the LOTS conference is that, as she told me, it's more than just about LOTS. Uh-huh. It's about the culture and community. Right. Yes. You know what I mean? Right. And as you can see with me and Stephon Bonin, we love a lot of stuff. You know what I mean? We love our hair, we love our bodies, but we love wrestling. We love comic books. We love anime. We love hip hop. We love all these things. And we grew up, a lot of us grew up on comic books. And my art, heavily comic book influenced, but now with the stuff I'm doing reflecting Nubian culture, people respond to that and they need that. So I have a home here.
I love it. So this is your fifth year here.
This is my fifth year here. Awesome. And this is the same weekend. Last few years, it's fallen on one of my biggest conventions. It's a convention where I make the most money I make a year, the New York Comic Con.
Okay.
It's just thousands and thousands and thousands of people go to that convention. You can't help but make money there.
Okay.
And every year that is falling on the same weekend, I choose the LOTS conference.
Because it's about the love.
That's the power of this convention.
The love. Support. Who supported you from the very beginning. I love it. Yeah. I love it. Don't forget.
I just realized I have to teach a workshop.
Oh, no, I'm with you. I'm definitely with you. It's past 3:30. So we're definitely going to get your, give yourself a shout out. Let the people know exactly where they can find you, how they can stay locked, and check out this comic book once it drops.
All right. So, again, my name is Sean Aleen. You can find me on Instagram on Pyroglyphics1, PYROGLYPHICS1. Find me on Facebook, Pyroglyphics Studio. Just Google me. My art is all over. And also, so be please follow me because I'll be giving updates soon. As I said, I have the art gallery coming out in December, the Afrofuturist Art Gallery.
I love it.
I also have a bunch of material online that you may not be able to get here since I just came back from traveling.
Awesome.
So hit me up.
No doubt, man. Make sure you guys hit him up. You can also find him on our InstaSnap at Revive_POC, too.
Real quick. Thank you guys for what you're doing. Thank you for having me on. I really appreciate this.
Thank you. Let's stay connected. I'm going to make sure we stay connected with you, man, because we definitely want to make sure that we get some things going on. And, you know, Stephon is always looking to grow. He's looking for some T-shirts. He's trying to create some T-shirts. And maybe you can help him with the design of the T-shirts and different things like that. We're going to keep this relationship going, Stephon. Yes. Definitely.
We'll see you on the show again, like, you know, later on. Like,
we have to.
Yes, definitely. Especially in December when it drops. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
Exactly.
Thank you
so we better go to a quick commercial break. Shout out to Sean, too, for being involved as well as being one of the workshop leaders today. Too. So make sure you get yours to that workshop so them people can learn. You already know what time it is. It's Meet Your Girl POC.
You are listening to Time for an Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
Are you an entrepreneur? Are you a startup business? Are you a local business? Are you an artist? Are you looking for someone to distribute your content? Revive Radio is the place to be. Come advertise with us at Revive Radio right now. You can find that advertising page at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Advertise with Revive. We are reaching thousands of millennials all across the world. And once again, reviveisalive.com is where you can find that information.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yep, yep, you know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl POC, host of Revive. Today is Winning Wednesday, so you already know each and every Winning Wednesday, we have a jam-packed show for you guys here on Time for the Awakening. I need you guys to give us a call right now, 215-490-9832. Once again, that number is 215-490-9832. And you already know, reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com is the place for you to be. Click that link in my bio, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_POC. Yep, you know what time it is, man. It's me, your girl, POC, host of Revive Radio. I need you all out there to do one thing for me right now. Spread the word, spread the message that Revive is alive. Once again, Revive is alive. And I need you guys to go check out our website at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. And follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_POC.
What's buzzing? Lost in a world.
The greats think differently. The greats see differently, right? The greats have a different worldview. The greats, they approach the game in a totally different way. So I need you to do me a huge favor. I need you to think about what you're thinking about when your effort is low. Because if you can get this, if you can get this, you can get any success you want in life. You can have anything you want in life if you can get this. The next time you give a low effort, right? You give it 70% or 50% or 30%. I want you to think about what you're thinking about when your effort is low. If your effort is low, you're probably not thinking about the opportunity. You're probably thinking about the obligation. And when you think about E.T., how you stay pumped up. E.T.'s how you stay on fire. E.T., how you always driven, even in the midst of trials and tribulations, even in the midst of your haters, when people try to break you and tear you down. E.T., how you stay strong. I keep thinking about the opportunity. Every single day, I'm thinking about the opportunity, and I'm not looking at this thing as an obligation. I'm not looking at this thing as something that I have to do or that I'm forced to do, right? Something that somebody's making me do. Every time I wake up, I'm thinking, I'm alive, baby. This is the day. This is an opportunity. If you want what you've never had before, if you want to do what you've never done before, if you want to be what you've never been before, change your mentality. And I want you to see that effort goes up when you look at it as, I got an opportunity of a lifetime. But you should be excited about the fact that you have an opportunity.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? It's the truth. Truth series.
I'd like to read a poem that I did for a sister who took her child to a crack house and left her child. Poem for some women, huh? I'm all right, I say I'm all right. What you're looking at, I say I'm all right. Doing okay, I'm still writing, producing on the radio. Who I fooling? I'm a little ill now, just got a little Jones habit. Took my 7-year-old to the crack house with me on Thursday. Beautiful girl, prettiest little girl her mama done ever seen. Took her so she understand why I late sometimes with her breakfast, dinner, bedtime meetings, bedtime love. Wanted her to know how hard it is for me, you know, a single woman out here on her own, you know. So I took her to the crack house where this man, this dog, this former friend of mine lived, wouldn't give me no crack, no action. Even when I opened my thighs to give him some again for the umpteenth time, he said no, all the while looking at my baby, my pretty little baby, and he said, I want her, I need a virgin. Your pussy's too loose. You had so much traffic up your pussy, you could park a truck up there and still have room for something else. And he laughed this long laugh, and I looked at him and the stuff he was holding in his hand. You know, I couldn't remember my baby's name. He held the stuff out to me, and I couldn't remember her birthday. I couldn't remember my daughter's face, and I cried as I walked out that door. What's her name? Puddin' Tang. Ask me again, I'll tell you the same thing. Couldn't even hear her screaming my name as she tore into her pretty little panties. Prettiest little girl you done ever seen. Prettiest little mama's baby you done ever seen. Bought my baby this pretty little leather jacket off the street when I went to pick her up on Sunday. 7 days later, walked right up to the house, opened the door, saw her sitting on the floor. She said, Mama, where you been? Mama, I call for you. Mama, 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 they hurt me something back. I want to go home, mama. Mama's little baby, love shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby, love shortening bread. Put on the jacket, put on the jacket. Mama's little baby, love shortening bread. When we got home, She wouldn't talk to me. She just sat and stared, wouldn't watch the TV when I turned it on. When we got home, she just stared at me with her eyes. Dog-like, just sat and looked at me with her eyes till I had to get out of there, you know. My baby ran away from home last week. My sweet little shortened bread ran away from home last night, and I dreamed she was dead. Dreamed she was surrounded by panthers who tossed her back and forth, nibbling and biting and tearing her up. My little shortened bread ran away from home last week. Peekaboo, 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 I see you and you and you and...
On Status is from Spice of Dawns, a book of verses by Vivian Ayers, who is my mother. "'Twas many a year since I left home, a girlish girl, Hades bent to roam. Can't take this town, I used to say. It's dull and quiet, country way. So, I boarded a train, kissed all goodbye, and in my heart was a sentimental sigh, for I would go to live in a city where buildings and people and hearts were bigger, while they remained to work and toil in a town whose thriving was of soil. For long it worked. I knew no distress. I even dared to write them less. What need had I for folk degenerate whose living and thinking were out of date? Then one quiet day, I found myself confusion bound, problems high as Jack's beanstalk, and nobody with whom to talk. My dilemma was all my own. No counseling dad, no kindness shown. And for once, I knew my status. Cockroach in the Park Theater. Now my heart knows no delight like a trip to the old home site. Not for money would I scoff at a screen door hanging off. So they've got no tall skyscrapers, clowns in nightclubs cutting capers. It's home. The folk are warm. And most of all, I belong."
I want to do dumb things. I'm talking strolling in the park things. Stealing kisses straddled on park swings in the daylight while the ice cream van sings a little melody for us to move to like... I'm talking some midnight dedications of rare groove tunes, and we're all across London. We use it, real names too, because we're not fazed by who call who a fool. See, I want to do everything with you, so
I fantasize about
see you just
sit every day, and I want to do just
everything. Say, baby, say everything, and now I wanna run holding hands. See, I know that we can do this in a field of purple grass sprayed with green or white tulips under a sky washed orange by an everlasting sunset. You know what? I ain't done yet. See, I want to catch a ride off some crimson-colored stallion. We can sail a boat made of water straight into the horizon. Or we can catch a lift on a cloud that silver lining's really platinum. But you know what? I still ain't done yet. See, I want to... And I was thinking we could...
Sit over, baby.
And if you wouldn't mind a little...
Oh, yeah.
And if you're ready, we can always...
Oh, baby.
I wanna be on the phone with you for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. I'm no longer scared of your future, baby, because after tonight I'm gonna be in your history forever. See, I
fantasize about
you just every day, and I say, do just say everything, say everything. Say everything, say that I
said every day, and I want to do just everything. For you. Said baby, you. Said everything that I fantasize about you. Said every day, and I want to do.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time. It's your girl POC. Hey. It's your girl POC.
Yep. You know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive Radio. We are back live once again. We are live broadcasting down here. Yes, we are broadcasting live right now at the 24th Annual Philadelphia Lock Conference, man. We are live on reviveisalive.com. Make sure you guys follow us Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_POC. Don't forget to check us out on YouTube, and don't forget to subscribe to our beautiful newsletter that comes out once a month. You can do that at reviveisalive.com. Shout out to this purple bag right here. They got the purple rain dripping all down her, you know what I'm saying, all down on her arm. She got the Prince bag pulled out. I love her bag right here, man. I see some amazing pieces, clothes, head wraps, dreads, locks, earrings, rings, watch. I'm keep going, right? Green beans, potatoes. Like, nah, I'm playing. Well, we got another special guest in the building with us as well. Stefan, go ahead and introduce her.
Yes, so we have here Kendall from Inside Out Beauty Studio.
Yes.
She has, well, I'm going to let you go ahead, but I was going to say she has some amazing products that I smelled, that I felt earlier. They are amazing. And you have such simplicity to your products because...
Because all of my products are either under 4 ingredients or less.
Yes.
Stuff to get what you have, but you don't.
Exactly.
Yes. And name your business one more time. What's the name of your business?
Inside Out Beauty Studio.
Inside Out Beauty Studio. And why Inside Out? What does that mean?
Well, I believe beauty starts from the inside out.
That's
so
a fact.
Beautiful spirit. And then also just the things that we put in our bodies. And then also things that we have on, you know, we put out on the outside of our bodies should be just as complimentary.
I'm with it. And you can use, you got some beauty inside and out right now.
So
you know what
sweet.
I'm saying? Make sure you guys check her out for real. She got a beautiful hair color.
Thanks.
You are here dripping for the people today. But when it comes to the beauty inside out, how are your products helping us when it comes to developing, you know, self-care? Because in order to get that inside out, we got to have that self-care.
Right. So, first of all, I really believe in the power of essential oils and
awesome.
Also the power of aromatherapy.
I put it right up under my nose, girl.
Exactly.
Right up under it.
Scent can lift your mood. Mm-hmm. It can actually, you know, heal. It can do a lot of amazing things. And so I always take the time to really research and look at what oils or fragrances I'm actually going to infuse into my body care products.
Mm-hmm.
So our foot soak, actually, for instance, I call it triple L, triple love.
Okay.
So it's lemon, lime, and lavender.
Ooh.
So those are all uplifting scents, but also the lavender is soothing, and it helps the muscles. So that's really important. Lemon and lime actually draw out impurities. It's antibacterial for the body.
Okay.
So those things are important.
All right.
Right? So my philosophy is that less is definitely more in a lot of ways, and also people should really just really read and think about what they're putting on their skin.
I agree with you on that. I definitely agree with you on that. Shout out, you know what I'm saying?
It is.
Shout out to that combination right there, because that's a crazy combination, and a lot of people wouldn't even think about putting that combination together, so that's really amazing. But when it comes to the essential oils, they're just like crystals and stones. All of them have their own meaning. All of them are used for their own purposes, you know what I'm saying? So when it comes to making sure that someone is taking care of themselves when it comes to like maybe like a headache or a head cold, what would be the oil that you would recommend for them?
Stuffy head, I always go for eucalyptus.
That's my baby! I burn it every day, all day, 24 hours a day. I try to put some lemon in it. They got a eucalyptus with some lemon in it. And it will make your house smell like pine salt.
A little bit of lemongrass also is good. So lemongrass is good. I'm trying to think. What else? Maybe I'm not crazy about the smell, but I know tea tree is good.
I put it in my hair sometimes too.
It's really So trying to keep all those germs and all that stuff away. Anything citrus based, I think also, again, it's uplifting, but also will help clear out. But my go-to is eucalyptus.
And it's definitely my go-to is eucalyptus too as well.
Absolutely.
I'm with you on that. And when it comes to essential oils too, a lot of people don't want to invest in it because it comes in like maybe like a really small jar. They think they're not going to get the bang for their buck.
Because
oil is really like $7, $9 if you buy the good kind. You know what I'm saying? Yes. So how are you pushing, you know, your products to allow us know that we are getting the bang for our buck when it comes to getting essential oils, and it's a good investment?
Well, this is the thing about essential oils. You don't want some things you don't want diluted. Some things have to be diluted, and so you have to really be careful about like putting essential oils straight on your skin.
Okay.
So, like I said, my products are actually buffers for that. So, I actually have a shea butter moisturizer, which I call a fluff. It's actually whipped to perfection. It's amazing. Ooh. But I have a jojoba oil in that. Mm-hmm. So, if you are going to infuse that with a little bit of eucalyptus or even tea tree, because sometimes those things can actually sting or burn the skin.
Mm-hmm.
So, you want to make sure that you have carrier oils that are high quality. You want to make sure that you're going to reputable people and companies when you actually get buy any type of natural or essential oils.
Mm-hmm. And when also you keep using this word infuse, I love that you keep saying infuse. Why do you choose that word infuse?
Well, that's just the language I'm used to.
Okay.
I am a licensed esthetician. Those are some of the things that we do, you know.
Okay.
That's the language that we use.
Okay. Okay.
But I think it's better than saying I just put it in there.
That's what I was. And that's why I wanted to ask you. I actually like that verbiage better because it makes me think like, okay, it's a little something in there. You know, she spiked it up just a little bit for me. She infused that, right? So that's why I was feeling it. But I also wanted to ask you too, because when it comes to burning these oils, people burn them in so many different ways. Some people dip the oil on an incense and then they burn the incense.
Yep.
Some people do the essential diffuser.
My
yep, I do the diffuser.
Thing, I do a diffuser.
We twins for real. We twins.
Yes.
So, I love my diffuser. I keep my diffuser on all the time.
Absolutely.
I actually put it in my bathroom. It actually helps me like when I'm like, it's like a calming, cooling feeling and refreshing when I'm in the shower and I have the eucalyptus burning behind me.
That's right.
I keep my diffuser in my bathroom. But I wanted to ask you, what's the best way to do it where it's not chemical or harming yourself at the same time?
Again, I think the diffuser is good because again, it's a method to actually disperse those essential oils into the air, into the atmosphere, which is good. And it doesn't like, you know, sometimes it has a little bit of, you know, you add a little bit of water.
I wanted to ask you that though. Do you think the water actually takes away from the powerful scent that it can be without the water?
It depends on if your apparatus calls for it or not.
Okay.
So, like, for instance, before I had my diffuser, this is a long time ago, before I had my diffuser, I used to cut up lemons and limes and actually a little bit of maybe cinnamon or whatever, and I would put it in boiling water.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then that would fragrance my house.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't think water necessarily dilutes it unless you're actually putting it in something.
Okay.
So, like, for instance, like, my products don't have any water in them.
Okay, okay.
It's straight oil with straight oil.
Okay.
So you're getting the benefits of the oil.
She got slogans right there. I love it. I love it.
So, I love water, but sometimes water moisture introduces bacteria to your product. So you have to also be very careful about that as well.
Okay. So. And I wanted to ask you this last question too, right?
Yes.
So us as women, you know, we want to smell good. We want our entire body smelling good, you know, even down to our yoni sometimes. So when it comes to putting oil, you know, and essential oils down there in our areas, would you recommend it? Because
no.
I know a lot of women, you know, because we put the, but I asked you this, but the reason why I asked you this is because instead of going to like the Bath and Body Works and getting the blossoms and the, you know, all of those cherry blossom flavors that they have for us, I'm saying like, what can we use to still get that same smell? That's the reason why I'm asking, because I know some women who just say, I'm put the oil down there, but I'm like,
you might want to actually have a carrier oil with that. Definitely. I would say that's something I'm a purist, I guess, when it comes to that. if I'm going to put any type of oils on my my lady parts, my okay.
She definitely thought about that. Like, how can I be politically correct right now?
I would do things like oils that I would use to infuse the oil. So like maybe like a sweet almond oil,
okay,
or jojoba oil, which actually jojoba also
it goes in your hair too. Yeah, I put it in my hair.
Actually, it mimics the sebum or the oils in our skin. Mm. So that is a very safe oil to use. So if people are a little scared about what kind of oil should I use and what can I put on my skin or mm-hmm. what can I put on my face or whatever. Jojoba oil is a good choice.
Okay.
You don't have to slather it on.
Okay.
You know, oils are, the way they are dispersed in the body or whatever, they'll travel, they move. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to necessarily be like an oil slick, you know, to get the benefits from those oils.
Okay.
But I would be very careful, ladies, when you're putting anything scented or fragranced.
So would you recommend them stop using the Bath and Body Works and stop using all that bubble bath with the fragrances and all that stuff? Because I even dropped the oil in my, like, if I'm taking a bath, I drops the oil in there.
That's fine. That part is fine too. But again, you have a buffer. Mm-hmm. You may have another. You have a carrier oil in that if you're using a carrier oil with the essential oil, and you also have water.
Okay. Okay. So, the diluting. That's what you were talking about. Okay.
Exactly,
okay. Okay.
Exactly. Exactly. Because you have to be very careful with oils too. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're great or whatever, but in excess, they go kind of wonky. I get you.
Not the wonky.
Yeah, so would crazy. Bath and Body Works stuff, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm a mother.
Mm-hmm.
This part of my business, like I said, I'm a licensed esthetician. I'm a makeup artist.
You do it all.
Yeah. So this part of my business is fairly, is evolving. It's fairly new to what Inside Out it is. Mm-hmm. But I would say I've been making my products for maybe like 3 years.
Okay, you ain't new to this. Well, you ain't no baby no more. You a terrible three, baby. You ain't no baby.
I'll take that. But my son actually has psoriasis.
Okay.
And so going to the doctor with my husband and trying to like find things for my son, it was very, you know, disheartening. Mm-hmm. The things that I would say, oh, great, the doctor prescribed this or the doctor said, let's try this. And I would turn it over and it was like 30 ingredients. And I was like, I'm not doing this to my kid. I'm not doing this to my son. So I started making my fluff.
Okay.
Which is, like I said, only 4 ingredients. I can tweak whatever I put in there. So I use different oils for his skin mm-hmm. that work well for maybe somebody that has like a skin condition like psoriasis or, you know, possibly
eczema. I was about to ask you about a friend of mine that has a skin condition and like what's best, like he has problems with his feet. So like what's the best, typically his problem is like dry skin.
So he needs more hydration. So first, I would say this.
Don't try to play my black man feet. They trying out here. They trying.
I will
like be okay and just have pretty feet in general. All right. No,
I would actually some things obviously not I think it's important to actually maybe check with a medical professional.
Okay.
So right. Let me preface that first.
She ain't no foot doctor. That's what she tried to say.
I'm not. However, I think things that are rich in hydration, like avocado seed oil, is amazing for that. Mm-hmm. Amazing.
You can eat avocado seed oil, too.
You can. So avocado seed oil is good. I would say definitely, you know, your shea butters are good. Right. Like those nut butters are really good to get some hydration into the skin.
Okay.
In regards to essential oils, he said he's very dry, though.
Yeah, like it'll like flake up, kind of.
Get him the
going back to the.
You gotta
the
get him the fluff. He don't need no oil. We about to give him some fluff. Make sure you buy him some fluff on your way out the door.
but I would also, I would urge your friend also to go see a podiatrist. See what's going on with his skin, with his feet. Because it may be something like an underlying condition. Like,
right,
for instance, it could be that.
Right.
It could be something like psoriasis, which, like I said, we went a more natural route with we did with my son because his feet were, flaking, peeling off, like the skin. It was really bad. Mm. But, like I said, we a lot of that also has to do with we changed his diet a little bit too.
Lay off the dairy, people.
Yes, I agree with you with that one.
And I'm not trying to sound like I'm some sanctimonious vegan.
Right.
No, you sound like you're giving them people the truth. I appreciate you telling my listening audience the truth. We don't want nobody getting on here telling them nothing that ain't real.
Exactly.
So I appreciate you for doing that, honestly, truly. And I also want to say thank you for, you know what I'm saying, coming through and being a business owner at that, you know.
And then also a beautiful event.
Exactly. I was going to say, and being a part of this event, because this is my first time here. Is this your first time here?
This is actually not my first time attending the LOX conference, but this is my first time venting at the LOX
conference. So you've been able to see both sides of it.
Yes, I have.
So as a vendor, would you say you will come back next year and be a vendor again?
Absolutely. Can I shout out Miss Sakina Sabri as well?
Yes.
She's amazing. She actually, I just love her to death. We are sorority sisters, and we're also we're school counselors.
Awesome. What school are you guys at?
She's at King. I'm at Building 21.
Who's at King?
Sakina.
Really?
Yeah, she's a counselor at King.
The crazy part is we're actually going to be hosting Martin Luther King's homecoming. Next Friday the 12th. So you will be seeing us more often, Stephon. We got to remember this face right here.
I got to come and visit her. I'm literally right down the street. I'm on Limekiln at Building 21 High School.
Awesome. We're going to make sure.
Awesome students and my awesome staff there. I love you all. I don't know if you guys are listening.
They're going to be following you on Instagram now.
We talk with them. Yeah.
Okay.
The alumni there.
Okay.
We met the principal as well.
Miss Keisha.
Keisha.
Mm-hmm.
At Building 21?
No, at Kim.
Oh,
I mean,
at King.
At King. I'm sorry, at King.
Okay,
King. Okay, yeah, so.
But Ms. Kim first, and then Keisha came in.
Okay. They're probably awesome. I don't know.
I'm with you. But before we let you go, I definitely just want you to give yourself a shout out, let the people know how they can find your business, any information that we need to know to contact you, so we come get this fluff, some oil,
all the
above.
Okay, so again, it's Inside Out Beauty Studio. You can reach me actually at 215-874-7195.
Mm-hmm. So that's you gotta repeat that one more time.
215-874-7195. That's how you can reach me. You can also you can email InsideOutBeautyStudio@gmail.com. You can also reach me on Instagram, which is, again, Inside Out Beauty Studio on IG. Not on Twitter. Not a big fan of Twitter.
Okay.
And I actually cannot stand Facebook. Sorry, people. I know Facebookers, but that's just not my thing. So if you want to reach me, you can reach me. The most direct way is probably by phone, and definitely on Instagram. DM me, and I will reach out.
All right, and I want to say one more thing, too, because you are a multi-talented business owner, so you have other businesses, too. Do you want to talk about a little bit about your other businesses that you have?
Oh, so
plug yourself in. Let's do it.
Again, Inside Out Beauty Studio, again, I am a licensed esthetician, so I do facials. I don't wax anymore, actually, people. I sugar. Mm-hmm. So I got a certification of sugar, so that's a more natural route for hair removal, which I absolutely recommend. I absolutely love.
I want to reach out to you.
What else do I do? Makeup. Getting back into lash extensions, because I did lash extensions. And really just loving, like, trying to do products.
I love it.
So the closer I get to 50, I'm like,
and the reason I wanted to ask you to bring that out of you, too, because I love women who love to make other women feel just as special as them.
Absolutely.
So I appreciate the work that you're doing, man.
Thank you.
And definitely, one more time, get that telephone number out so anybody who listening can definitely give you a call.
It's Inside Out Beauty Studio, 215-874-7195. Thank you so much for having me.
No doubt, man.
I appreciate you.
Thank you. Inside and out, man. Go find that beauty. Go find that self-care. We about to go to a quick break, man. We about to wrap it up here today at the 24th Annual LOX Conference. We're going to speak to one more person. We're going to get an actual volunteer on the, you know what I'm saying? We want to know why you guys volunteered today for this beautiful event. We want to know why you're working for free, because sometimes you got to work for free. But I want to know why you chose to work for free for today. I appreciate you guys tuning in, man. Make sure you guys spread the word, spread the message. We are live on reviveisalive.com. Let's go.
For Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
Not a Wu-Tang-a.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? It's the truth series. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time.
Are you an entrepreneur? Are you a startup business? Are you a local business? Are you an artist? Are you looking for someone to distribute your content? Revive Radio is the place to be. Come advertise with us at Revive Radio right now. You can find that advertising page at reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com. Advertise with Revive. We are reaching thousands of millennials all across the world. And once again, reviveisalive.com is where you can find that information. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready?
The truth.
Are you ready? Are you ready for the truth? It's the truth series.
Yep, yep, you know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, PLC, host of Revive. Today is Winning Wednesday, so you already know each and every Winning Wednesday. We have a jam-packed show for you guys here on Time for the Week. And I need you guys to give us a call right now, 215-490-9832. Once again, that number is 215-490-9832. And you already know reviveisalive.com. Once again, reviveisalive.com is the place for you to be. Click that link in my bio, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Revive_PLC.
You are listening to Time for an Awakening Media, part of the Black Talk Radio Network. For podcasts or live programming, hit them up at timeforanawakening.com.
Not a Wu-Tanger.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time.
About that time.
It's your girl POC.
Yep, you know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, host of Revive Radio. We are back live right now on reviveisalive.com. We are here right now with your girl, Tiffany White. We actually stole her from her table right now, so she's double working right now. She's like, what's going on?
I got sale. Don't move. I'll be right back.
Tiffany, how you feeling today, man? How you feeling?
I'm good. I'm great. Just excited to be here. This is like a wonderful experience, a cultural experience.
Yes,
that's
indeed.
Empowering to me, you know.
And that's why we wanted to actually bring you on, is because we wanted to make sure that we got one of the volunteers on today, because when you volunteer, you do something out of the love of your heart. You volunteer because you actually have a passion for it, you care for something, or you care for someone. And we was like, we got to figure out why somebody would want to volunteer here today. Well, now we know, because we actually here and we see it ourselves in person. I want to volunteer too. Sheesh. You know what I'm saying? But why did you actually decide to volunteer today?
Well, I've been coming to the Lock Conference for 3 years.
Shout out to your beautiful locks too.
Thank
by the
you.
Way yes
I've
yes
had, I had my locks for 3 years now.
Yes,
I was invited by my hairdresser, who's here, Shanice.
Hairdresser or a lock technician? You know, they get a little bougie nowadays.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So I came and I was just like, oh my god, this is so awesome. Mm-hmm. I was like, I wonder how I can get involved and volunteer. So I was at the nail shop one day, and mm-hmm. just so happened one of the volunteer coordinators was in a nail shop getting her nails done.
Universal, that's what I'm talking
yes.
about. Yes, yes.
And I was like, you know, she had locks, of course. And I was like, you know about the lock conference? And she was like, yeah. She said, I'm a volunteer coordinator. I was like, oh, my God, I want to volunteer. So she gave me her information, and we stayed in contact. I went to all the meetings, and I had
Hello. How are you, beautiful? How are you?
I went to all the meetings, and, you know, I was there on time. Very organized, very well put together. We got to network with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was like, I'm ready.
So was it an easy process to actually sign up to become a volunteer? Or is it like a strenuous process? You got background check, fingerprints, FBI, all
that.
But
yes, all of that's included. But it was really like an easy process. It wasn't difficult to do. Just come to the meetings. We did little different scenarios. Mm-hmm. You know, if something was to happen during the conference, how would you react as a volunteer?
Okay.
And then we had the opportunity to sign up either for whatever position that we wanted to do.
Oh, you had to pick
hours.
What you wanted.
Yeah.
And what you wanted, what time you wanted to be here.
Yes.
Awesome. That's what I'm talking about.
Yes,
you know
yes.
what I mean? Some people get a little bossy when they sign
yes,
up for
right,
us.
Right.
So did you, are you going to be volunteering both days, Saturday and Sunday?
Yes, I will be volunteering just today.
Okay.
But tomorrow I'm coming to shop.
Okay, tomorrow I'm coming to shop. So when you
but
signed up.
But you can do both days.
Okay, you can do both days. So when mm-hmm. you signed up, what did you actually sign up to do? What did you say you wanted to do?
I wanted to actually be out here in the front.
Okay.
With the promo table, possibly over there signing the people in. That's
why
pretty
you
much
to
it.
Come out here and do that.
I don't know. I guess I just wanted to see people coming in.
And she do this, too. She's being modest right now, because, like I was telling her before we got live, I seen her at Councilman Kiana Johnson's, you know, Community Day, and she was back there coordinating everything back there, too. And then when she was coordinating the media, you know, right now, and we could be a little hectic, you know, because we want our pictures, we want our interviews,
right.
But she was shutting it down. So that's why they got her out here in the front. You know what I'm saying? Just in case they got to shut something down, you know what I'm saying? Tiffany is right there, you know, right by the door. So you wanted to be in front of the door. So how has it been for you so far? You know, you've been here all day, all morning so far. It's only 4 o'clock. It's going all the way up until 9 p.m. Are you staying to 9?
Well, I'll go on break at 5:30.
Okay.
And then from 5:36, I'll be on break, and then they're gonna have me somewhere else.
Okay.
And I'll be here till 8.
Okay. So how did it feel for the first half, being up here in front?
Good. I feel great. I mean, I'm not tired. I'm not prepared for this. My shift was 2 to 8.
Okay.
You know, so that's the shift that I picked. You know, just based on, you know, how I can get here and everything. But I feel fine. We're getting a lot of sales over there with the t-shirts.
And you're like the first person to see. Well, we're all the first person to see all these beautiful faces, the hair, the clothes, the kids. I mean, they bringing the kids by the bundles. You see what I'm saying? We don't need no babysitter this weekend, baby. No. You know what I'm saying? So how does it feel to see these faces? Because the first thing they're doing is stopping at your table to either grab a t-shirt or ask you a question. So how is it seeing? You know, they're coming in all shapes, sizes, and colors. You know, how does it feel?
What I like about it is like you said, different backgrounds, different cultures, different folks that's just interested in seeing what's going on here at the LOC conference. I do like the fact that it's holistic health.
Yes, yes.
You know, and I also tell people you don't have to have LOCs to come.
That's true, too, because there's a lot of hairstyles out here.
Exactly, because there's so many businesses. I'm a big supporter of black-owned businesses.
Yes, yes.
Big supporter of them. And sometimes if we got to pull our people up, we got to pull them up.
And we got to pull them up by the bootstraps.
Exactly. By the bootstraps. They can be on point at all times.
But we all got our Sunday best on today. So let me tell you that. We got our Sunday best on. We put it on. And we got the iron about the closet, too, because a lot of us ironed our clothes today. I seen it. I said, like, oh, you ironed that skirt this morning.
People are looking impeccable out here.
Yes.
Like, impeccable. It's beautiful.
And what's the shirts about? You're selling shirts for the actual event. And what's the shirts about? Is it the logo? Is there a message on there? What's on the shirts?
The message is also, the shirts are based on what's going on for this year. And then we have some past shirts from last year.
Okay.
We also have sweatshirts, you know, that's like $20 for the sweatshirts. The t-shirts are $2 for $20, $1 for $12.
Awesome.
And then the volunteers get these cool shirts as well.
Very cool shirts with the Adinkra symbol on them. I'm really feeling that.
Everybody been asking me about my shirt, like, I want that one.
And then my last question to you as well, because I know you got to get back to work, is so when you do come here tomorrow to shop and then actually enjoy the conference, what are you actually trying to get out of it tomorrow as actual patron? Because right now you're working, but what are you trying to get out of it by just coming and being someone who's going to experience
food,
it?
The food.
Oh, it was amazing. Let me tell you that now. We had some vegan food in there. Yeah, we had some. I had my very first vegan crab cake today.
The jewelry that I see. I'm big on earrings. I love my LOC earrings. Everything. Just everything.
I was trying to talk to you. You was working. So she was working too. Y'all all working.
Y'all all working.
Yes, yes. And her jewelry. Yes, indeedy.
Yes, look your hands back and forth,
bro. Yes. But no, so when you get here tomorrow, you're going to be looking for the food, the jewelry, and what else? Are you going to do some workshops? Networking.
I think that's what I'm going to do. I didn't do any workshops last year, so I'm interested in going to some of the workshops and checking them out.
And you come in here tomorrow by yourself? Because you came today by yourself. You're going to bring some family, some kids. What you going
to
bring tomorrow?
With me. Okay. I done posted on Instagram.
Awesome.
Instagram
get your little
live.
Selfies. I'm live, baby.
Yes. My boss actually wanted me to do something today. I was like, I'm going to the LOC conference. All right.
I'm off work, lady. Right. It's Saturday. I'm off work. I'm volunteering today.
Right. I'm volunteering for somebody else, you know? So
I'm with you, man. I appreciate you coming through. And one more time, for the people who are not here, but they will be here tomorrow, but they want to come cop a t-shirt, let them know how they can get the t-shirts and how much the t-shirts are.
Right, so the t-shirts are $1 for $12, $2 for $20.
That's
soon
not
as
bad.
You come in the door, they're right here. And then we have the sweatshirts, they're for $20.
Awesome, man. You're gonna see your girl Tiffany smiling beautifully as always as soon as you walk through the door up until about 5 o'clock. So if you want to see her face, make sure you're there.
Right.
Make sure you're there, man. I appreciate you, Tiffany, for coming through, man. Thank you for blessing the airways. Don't tell them we took you off work. You know what I'm saying? We don't want to get you in no trouble.
Right.
If they ask, tell them to come talk to Stefan. Man, we about to go to a quick break, man. Right after this break, you'll be back with me, your girl POC, and Stefan Lamar. Thank you, Tiffany.
All right.
Show up in my news feed. Man, I'm done with social media. All the injustice and brutality going around, and it's like they're trying to suppress our voice. We're trying to get the message out there, and you can't even share empowerment and what's going on around the country either.
Nah, don't be dumb with social media, though. It's a tool, and there is a place where we have a voice. It's a Let's Buy Black 365 social network. You do anything you would on any other social network. Post pictures, videos, status updates, share resources and community news. But on Let's Buy Black 365, it's a platform for us and by us to tell our messages.
Whoa, that's like a digital underground railroad.
What's the name of that site again?
It's letsbuyblack365.com.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's all about networking, and you get points, right?
Yeah, the more you network, post, and share, the more points you get. Plus, you get points for posting pictures, sharing information, attending community events, and inviting others to network with you on the app.
Wow, that's all I need to know. I'm gonna go download that app right now.
Now, better yet, let me invite you so I can get some points. It's all about empowerment and solutions, y'all.
Yeah, that's what's up. I'm all in.
Let's do it. Let's share our stories.
Let's buy Black 365.com.
put the thing down. Look up. You're missing stuff. What is the long-term effect of too much information? We don't know, but we're finding out. I know in my country, the polarization of the electorate, a mean-spiritedness. We've gone from radio presidents to television presidents to internet presidents to BlackBerry presidents to a Twitter president. Where are we going? And I'm not just knocking that man. I'm talking about all of us. Can you put it down? Are you using it, or is it using you? And where is it leading you? And I'm not telling you, oh, I'm against the establishment and all of that. I'm telling you, at least ask yourselves, what is the long-term effect of too much information? What is it doing to me? Is there a need for 24 hours a day news? Is there 24 hours a day worth of news? Or is it opinions?
And the news reporter says, Jesus is white. She says it with a smile on her face, like it's the most obvious thing in the world. So sure of herself, of her privilege, her ability to change history, rewrite bodies to make them look like her. She says it the same way politicians say racism no longer exists. The same way police officers call dead black boys thugs. The same way white gentrifiers call Brooklyn home. She says it with an American accent. Her voice doing that American thing, crawling out of her throat, reaching to clasp onto something that does not belong to her. And I laugh to myself. What makes a black man a black man? Is it a white woman's confirmation? Is it her head nod? Is it the way she's allowed to go on national television and autocorrect the Bible and God himself tell him who his son really was? What makes a black man a black man? Is it the way reporters retell their deaths like fairy tales? Is it the way they cannot outrun a bullet? How can she say Jesus was a white man when he died the blackest way possible? With his hands up, with his mother watching, crying at his feet, her tears nothing more than gossip for the news reporters or prophets to document, with his body left to sour in the sun, with his human stripped from his black, remember that? How the whole world was saved by a black man? By a man so loved by God, he called him Ken, called him black. Now ain't that suspicious? Ain't that newsworthy? Ain't that something worth being killed over?
True desire in the heart for anything good is God's proof to you, sent beforehand to indicate that it's yours already. So the desire you have, that itch that you have to be whatever it is you want to be, in front of the camera, on the stage, behind the stage, that itch, that desire for good, is God's proof to you, sent already, to indicate that it's yours. You already have it. Claim it. Understand this. Understand this also. You have these dreams, and as Kenny said, dreams without goals remain dreams, just dreams, and ultimately fuel disappointment. Dreams without goals, yearly goals, life goals, daily goals, monthly goals, hourly goals, minute by minute goals. Dreams without goals are just dreams, and they ultimately fuel disappointment. Goals on the road to achievement cannot be achieved without discipline and consistency. You understand? Between goals and achievement are discipline and consistency. I pray that you all put your shoes way under the bed that night so that you got to get on your knees in the morning. And while you're down there, thank God for grace and mercy and understanding. We all fall short of the glory. We all got plenty. If you just start thinking of all the things you got to say thank you for, that's a day.
Come on.
That's easily a day. Right?
So you have all been given these gifts. We have a little boy in our show we're doing, Raising in the Sun. And we have a circle, we pray every day. And his prayer, this boy is prayed up. He just prays that we go out and touch someone tonight. He says, God, somebody out there needs us tonight. And we all have that unique gift to go out and touch people, to affect people. Understand that gift, protect that gift, appreciate that gift, utilize that gift, don't abuse that gift, treasure it. You have it, you already have it. And finally, I'll say this. You'll never see a U-Haul behind a hearse. I'll say it again. You'll never see a U-Haul behind a hearse. Now, I've been blessed to make hundreds of millions of dollars in my life. I can't take it.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. All I need is one mic. You know what time it is. Open up your ears. You know what time it is. Open up your mind. It's about that time. It's your girl POC. Hey. It's your girl POC.
Yep, yep, yep. You know what time it is, man. It's Meet Your Girl, POC, Hopes for Revive. We are back live. This is like my first time ever doing a four-hour show. I've never been on air for 4 hours before, I don't think. I talked this long before. Don't get me wrong, but I have never been on air for 4 hours. And it feels actually amazing. We talked to a lot of beautiful people today. We got to talk to a lot of black-owned businesses. We got to talk to a child today who's in 11th grade. That really made me excited because I had hair goals of hers. I was actually hyped over her hair, you know what I'm saying? Her locks were absolutely beautiful.
What was her name?
Oh, you was running around, baby. You was working. You was working. I gave you a shout out, though. I let everybody know you was out here working. You know what I'm saying? The reason why you don't hear his voice is because he's out here working right now. And then even when it was time to hear his voice, y'all, he still was trying to work. Like, but now I'm about to go back over there. I love it, though. I'm with it all the way. Both of you guys are working. Thank you guys for, you know what I'm saying, giving up your Saturday evening and morning. You know what I mean? Because they would have locked you out this morning if you wasn't here on time. So I appreciate you guys for coming through. Shout out to Harmony the Goddess for checking in on us as well. You know what I'm saying? Making sure the team is together and well. How would you say your day was as we're wrapping up, you know, our first day here at the Lock Conference on Saturday? How would you say your first day was?
Yeah, it was definitely exceptional, and incomparable in its own right because I experienced so many things here that I've never experienced. Mm-hmm. You know, so many different vendors and people and, you know, I would say the best congregation. Ooh. That's the thing.
Ooh.
The best congregation I have ever been a part of.
What's your other thing?
This is the best congregation I have ever been a part of, always and always. I'm sure it will always be because, like, it doesn't get much better than this.
And the best part about it, though, Stefan, is because who you are, you make connections everywhere you go. And everyone that, you know, who came up to the table, nine times out of ten, they came up to the table because you told them about it, because you were doing the running and everything. And you connected with everyone. And before they even sat down, they was like, oh, I love what you guys are doing.
Right.
So that means you did a great job at whatever you did today to, you know, bring them closer to the table, bring them closer to Revive. So I appreciate that. And now you even have, like, shout-outs, you know, of your friends, merchandise that you got going on and stuff like that.
Yeah, but first, I want to ask Alicia how her time was. How was your time, Alicia?
My time was absolutely amazing.
Shout out.
This is a community. Mm-hmm. I like what you said, but I feel like this is it's a community, and it has not.
Unity.
I haven't felt
in that
any
too type
of warmth like this before. It's just,
yo, I got a hug and I asked for a hug again. I said, oh, can't nobody hug me like that in a long time. Can I get another one of those? And she was like, oh, they don't come with good hugs nowadays. I said, but you do. Give me one. Give me one.
A plethora of hugs.
I hugged everybody I came in contact with today. I literally
very
hugged
few,
everyone I came in contact with today.
If one, like,
and everybody smelled good.
And if so, I think that handshake led into a hug. smoke. Mm-hmm. Yes, you know, so yes. Yeah. So.
Everybody smoke good. Did y'all get any bad smells today?
No, well, if I did smell somebody, I think I smelled them in passing. The great smells I was already
right,
smelling.
Right,
right. You know, it was just like.
Look at this little queen that just walked in the building.
Oh, and when I took that pause, that guy showed me and Alicia this picture. Oh, my goodness. It was the cutest thing. He had a dashiki made for his son.
Aww.
And he had a matching dashiki. It was just so cute.
And we have their information too, so we can shout them out.
Definitely.
Right, yeah, and his Insta is, well, the Instagram of the person that made their dashikis and the awesome piece of clothing that the brother had on is Kingston Culture.
Shout out to the designer.
Culture with a K. And it's
Cardi didn't make that up then.
So who?
Cardi B didn't make that up.
Culture with a K?
That's the name of her child.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I'm so out of the loop. I did not know that at all.
Okay, cool. We're going to keep it back. We're going to keep it back. We're going to keep it here.
So the person that made the awesome garment that I'm talking about is Kingston Culture. Kingston_culture.
All right, we got to make sure
like
we
I
find it.
Like I was saying, Culture with a K.
Culture with a K.
I'm just making sure. Yeah, yes. So... Kingston, KINGSTON _KOUTOURE.
Do you guys see this little doll baby?
I'm trying to get her.
Oh, my. And, like, the skin complexion, the facial expressions. Your daughter, I need to get her attention. Your daughter is absolutely gorgeous.
Yes, and so
she,
are you.
She, right? Yes, you too. But she's, like, walking in her own purpose right now. Like, she, like... just like a halo over top of this little baby right here. Hello, sir. How are you doing? Oh, my. Please take care of that sister of yours. Protect and guide her. Yes. Oh, my. She's got like a halo as she walked. Like, just, oh, right? Wonders of joy. I love your hair.
Before we go.
I wish I had names.
I just want to. I saw this lovely woman. I just ran like right into her as I was going to go get Kendall from Inside Out Beauty Studio. And I ran into this lady, Monique Anderson, and she told me about the Men's Coffee Talk 3rd Anniversary Summit. It used to be a United Bank.
Shout out to the dancers in the building. You know, the twins are in the building. Yes. I get jiggy with it. I had to shout them out real quick. Yo, Stefan, these two right here, they can move. They can physically move. They can even spin on their head sometimes. Like, they got a lot of tricks up their sleeve, for real, for real. Definitely. But go ahead, finish your shout out. I'm sorry, they walked out the door. I'm sorry, I had to make sure I got them kings out the way.
Right. So you guys, I ran into this awesome lady, Monique Anderson, and she handed me a flyer that referenced the Men's Coffee Talk 3rd Anniversary Summit. It's on 3750 Lancaster Ave, and it used to be the United Bank. It's an event that you can register through Eventbrite. And, yeah, it's just basically this is a think tank that gathers great, you know, like-minded kindred spirits. And they highlight panel discussions on biometrics, mental health screenings, economic opportunities, employment, and as well as community resources and networking. So you guys, it's going down November the 13th. If you have time, it's from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m., and it's going to be a great time. You know, the woman that I met, she was representing them, and the energy that I got from her was just outstanding. It was great.
Yes.
Also, at the same place, they have a poetry night. It's an open mic night, and it's called The Parable of the Sour. And they have actors, poets, rappers, and singers come out where they just, you know, freestyle and just, you know, present their craft. And that's on October the 12th.
Perfect. So you've been around, baby. Did you touch the whole building, you think? You touched the whole building?
Pretty much.
You touched the whole
building? It feels as though.
It feels as though.
It's a great feeling.
Did you make some connections? Do a lot of people know what the Attender Circle is and what you do?
I would say every guest that we had on the show and every person that I talked to them about what I did.
Awesome. Yo, Twin, I'm going to be hitting you guys up really soon. We're doing something on Friday the 12th at Martin Luther King High School, and I was thinking about you guys. I manifest you guys because I brought your name up yesterday when I was at Roxborough High School, and so just know I'm going to be reaching out, and I love the universe for bringing you in front of me right now. That's why I wanted to make sure I give you guys a shout out. Oh, no, I'm going to use this. Don't worry. worry. I'm going to use it. You don't got to worry about that. But yes, though, Stephon, you touched every part of this building. I didn't even go back in the gym. I walked through the gym, came through this morning. I seen everybody setting up, and then that was the end of that. So what does the gym look like right now?
I don't know. I didn't go back in there from the last time we left out.
Okay.
The food and everything. It's different in there now?
Well, I didn't, because everybody's set up now.
No, yeah, I think it's still just food in there. Yeah.
No, not the cafeteria, the gym. Remember we walked through the door this morning, and the first door we walked through. Yes.
Right. Yeah, they're both so vast. I thought it was like the same thing. It just looks the same. You know, more great, beautiful black people in there.
Okay.
People networking and, like, you know, buying things.
Okay.
Buying all the things that they need in their lives.
Okay.
You know, like.
Well, you have access to come back tomorrow as well. So would you be coming back tomorrow?
Okay. Yeah, I'm definitely going. Do I have anything else to do?
Would you recommend somebody to come back tomorrow?
Of course. Yeah,
okay.
I would implore people to come back.
Okay.
Just recommend.
All right. And the last question I have for you, because I don't know if you answered this, because I cut you off a little bit, and I do apologize for that. When it comes to the Attender Circle, did you let the people know about the Attender Circle, how they can catch you and everything going on?
Time and where. I told them that we're more so based on the internet, you know. I told them about what I talk about, how I open it up. The woman, Ashley Monique Anderson, the woman that I got these flyers from, she handed me this flyer about the open mic because I told her about my poetry and everything.
Awesome. You should have told her you just did one on Monday and you slayed it. Right. You slayed it. You opened it up.
I'm so happy that I got a chance to record. Not a chance, but that I recorded that Intended Circle. I didn't even know I was recording it.
We're going to make sure we get that on YouTube.
Yeah.
We got to make sure we get that up on YouTube.
It's a great one. It was a great one.
Definitely. And Alicia, I wanted to ask you too, so people can know where to find you, where they can find some of these pictures at, because you took some of the pictures about the people who were here today. So tell us a little bit about that, because once again, I asked you earlier, you were behind the lens, but as we're wrapping up, you know, from the start of the day to the end of the day, how did it get better for you?
Well, I can tell you that I was a little resistant to putting out my artwork today because I was not prepared. I was ill prepared. But in just putting out a little bit of my artwork that I did have in prints, everybody had wonderful things to say about it, so I was really excited to be able to do that.
Trust yourself in the process, baby.
Yes, and I got offered to do an illustration for a children's book, a few photography shoots, all without business cards. We're gonna work on that. But you guys can follow me at
Say Trees and do it a different way. What that guy was saying,
technology.
Yeah,
technology.
Nah, you need something in your hand. You need something in your hand, man.
See how it works for you, though. You can try it out.
Okay. We can try something different. We'll see.
But we're different because we're in media. I understand what you're saying, but you know. Deforestation is a problem.
Or just put on a sticker. I just put on stickers. I was like, yo, I don't really like business cards, but I would do a sticker myself. If somebody gave me a sticker, I would keep the sticker and find somewhere to put it versus a business card. I'm trying to figure it out. But as you know, me being in the entrepreneurship, you know, environment, I'm like, yo, I would rather keep the business cards now of others because I can create a network, and that network can create a net worth. So one day when I'm looking for someone, I'm like, yo, where are my business cards? And boom, I can go in my little fishbowl, pull out my business card, and I know exactly who I'm speaking with. So yeah, so I'm learning how to do it in a way where I'm not giving out business cards, but I'm receiving business cards.
Right.
But so what were we about to say? How can we stay in lock with you? How can we get some of these visuals as a day too?
You guys can follow me on Instagram at Exhibit A Art Design, EXHIBITA Art Design. I'm only on Instagram right now. We are trying to get a little bigger than that, but Instagram is where
we're
it's
not
at.
Trying. We are.
Let's we are.
Where you at, Stephon? Normally that's you changing the vocabulary from the try to the R. What's
up? He's tired. He's been working all day long.
All right, man. But we about to go ahead and wrap up anyway. So once again, shout out your Instagram for me, Alicia. Shout out your Instagram for me. You everywhere, just like Stephon. Everybody everywhere, but
I'm
right
sorry,
here.
I'm sorry, we're
come
like
on, so we can wrap the show up.
Yo, she was talking about me zoning out earlier, but how about that garment that we saw?
It was fun.
With the next piece.
It was everything. I'm sorry. Exhibit A Art Design on Instagram. EXHIBITA Art Design.
And if you got, you know, your picture taken by Alicia today, you can hit you up with your email so they can hit you up so you can send them pictures and things like
that. It's exhibitaartdesign@gmail.com. And for everybody that did sign up on our little registration, we will be sending out the pictures that we took here at the Lock Conference. And thank you so much for everybody stopping by.
No doubt, man. Revive is alive. And I am Stephon Lamar on all social media or just Instagram. We working on that.
Just IG. Well, soon. But I am on YouTube. But
that's what I want you to say. I think that's why I threw the shade right there, because I really want that YouTube to go up. You just told me you were excited about the Intender Circle. Why we can't put that on your YouTube?
Well, we can do that, but I don't know if I want people to go on there and watch the video that I have on there now.
Okay.
I took it so long ago, and it's like, well, don't look at me when I first came out.
You know what question I forgot to ask today, Stephon?
I figure out how to take it down.
You know what I forgot to ask?
No.
About these damn lock extensions you keep talking about. How are we going to be at the lock conference and not ask nobody about these lock extensions?
Well, you know what's so popping is that there's a woman here, I think the only hairdresser that came out, she does locking extension, and she's going to do mine, and I know her from somewhere.
Look at you all excited. Look at you all excited.
I don't know from where, but I know her from somewhere. I know her.
Okay.
I think it was like maybe when I was a child.
Okay.
But she has a very familiar face, and yes, she's going to do my locking extension, and she's here at the Lock Conference.
I'm going to ask that question off air. I'm going to try to put that on the social media, because I need to know how that feels. You know, it's a bunch of people in here with locks, so I need to know how they feel about that lock extension, right, man.
And it's a bunch of people in here, I'm sure, that may have, if they don't have locking extensions, you would not know that they had them because they're so popping.
That is true. I cannot tell right now because a lot of people here are like very, very gorgeous. I agree with you on that one.
I mean, you hear from Alicia, she would say go the natural way because mine are so beautiful. But, you know,
I'm just saying.
I actually seen a picture of Alicia. She came a long way.
Right.
She came a long way.
I mean, if you want to go back on the Instagram, it's there. It's there for everybody.
I'm just playing, man. But thank you once again for both of you coming out, Stephon. What's your Instagram one more time?
Right. Definitely
shout out to this aqua blue lock right here. This aqua blue locks. I love it. I love it. Yes.
Stephon Lamar.
One more time, Stephon. I apologize. I was hype over the aqua blue.
No problem. And I am Stephon Lamar. That's all lowercase. Look at Tiffany.
I'm right here.
Yes. Follow me, you guys. And I am Stephon Lamar. All lowercase.
Great way to end the show.
H-O-N-L-E-N-E-R.
No doubt, man. You already know what time it is. This Meet Your Girl POC, host of Revive, man. I am going live tomorrow starting at 11 a.m. You got to get up anyway, so why not get up with Meet Your Girl POC for that Sunday Good Morning Talk Radio, man. Make sure you guys spread the word, I can't even get it out. I'm so tired, man. Spread the word. Spread the message. We are live right now on revivalsalive.com each and every Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. I need y'all to turn your radios up. Spread the word. Spread the message. And definitely stay locked. Subscribe to both the YouTube channel and the newsletter for everything we got going on, especially these events. It's 444 right now, so that means we need to get off, man, the internal number. Let's go. You already know it's Meet Your Girl POC tomorrow, 11 a.m. Let's go. Shout out to the whole team.
Welcome to Revive. It's about that time. Welcome to Revive. It's about that time.
All I need is one mic.
You know what time it is. Open up your ears.